When you help your neighbor, you help your nation.
Shop Woodhouse Place Hyundai and Nissan, 144th and Giles. KOZN Bellevue, Omaha, Council Bluffs.
Crossover.
Oh, killer crossover.
Just crossover.
You just crossed him over. Danced him.
Another victim to the crossover.
Cross him up and sit him down.
Time for the crossover.
Hey!
John and Josh.
I was just making sure my button was working.
Are here.
You know how that button gets a little goofy and doesn't work all the time?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Just sounds like it's on. Are we ready for Big Ten football on Nickelodeon? What if we did
no.
it? I think it's a great idea.
That, you know, that could actually happen.
Big Ten game. Yes.
That could actually happen.
It's a CBS entity. CBS.
Yep.
Very in on the Big Ten now.
Yep.
I don't hate the idea.
What do you think Big Ten football coaches would think of getting slimed after the game?
Ooh, I think that Scott Frost would love it.
Me too.
It would mean a big win, so he'd probably love that.
I would think that.
How much would he pay to not get?
He's got young kids.
True. Don't talk about his family.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah.
Oh, my bad.
Do not bring up the family.
Do your kids watch Nickelodeon?
Don't ask. He has children.
Can you imagine if because they usually get one of the Nickelodeon child stars to do a guest shot in the booth? Can you imagine if all of a sudden the conversation turned to Frost kids and then Scott found out about it. He's like,
man,
who's mentioning my family on the air? And then he has to yell at some kid and bite his head off and
leave my family out of it.
No, the families, leave them out of it.
No, Scott, a big part of this is we talk about kids. We talk about, no, we do not.
No, no children allowed. You know, a Northwestern Purdue game would be perfect.
Absolutely.
For the slime bowl.
Absolutely. You can put it at Wrigley Field.
Exactly.
We could put it at Wrigley Field.
Yes.
With no end zones, and they just shoot slime out.
You know, that actually, I wouldn't be surprised if that doesn't happen at some point. I know it. I'm guessing it's not in the contract because they would have reported on it today.
I mean, CBS,
but I wouldn't be surprised if the Big Ten came to them and said, hey, you know, would you be willing to do this? And they would say, sure.
I mean, theoretically, CBS can do what it wants with it, right?
Yes,
I mean,
definitely.
Well, yeah, as long as the game airs where it's supposed to air. You know, the Nickelodeon game just gives them an extra channel that they're airing the game on.
Or inventory.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that'd be great. Actually, the perfect game.
SpongeBob!
The perfect game it would be to do it for is some, you know, random FCS school.
Yeah, Nebraska, North Dakota.
Even though, when you look at it, the NFL does it for playoff
games. They do it for a playoff game.
So. Oh, my God. I forgot. They do it for a playoff game.
That's the only time they do it, right?
In my head, it was, in my head, it was just a
rate.
Yeah, they still have a normal broadcast on regular CBS, which is great. But let's do a slime game, too. I don't see it.
Yeah, last year it was the Cowboys game, which I did not watch a second of on Nickelodeon.
Oh, that's right. It was.
I'm trying to see slime pop up when the 49ers score a touchdown.
The first one, it was Saints Bears.
Oh, what a horrible football game that was.
That was hilarious.
Yes.
I wasn't there.
Like Mike McCarthy probably was.
Yes, wasn't there
in slime.
There was a moment. I thought I saved it.
We don't have to watch anything from that game. Let's talk more about the Big Ten and how they don't care about men's college basketball anymore.
Wow,
the Big Ten conference,
that's not true.
The
that's
media
impossible.
Partners are like me. They're like, yeah, let's just throw it somewhere else. Who cares about it?
Peacock.
Why would you say that?
Spot the lie is what I would say.
What do you mean, spot the lie?
You see in their statement, they mentioned golf, but like they're like, yeah, some of these games are going to be on Peacock now all the time moving forward.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, it'll be just a few. I'm sure not the best Big Ten basketball games will be on.
But not the best, but like most of the Nebraska games probably.
Yeah.
Well, that's what I said.
That
not
sucks.
The best.
I'm going to have to subscribe to Peacock now to watch Nebraska basketball.
So I was thinking about it. Like you
Bummer.
Get, I don't know how I have some of these things, but I have Peacock.
I used to.
By the way, I did find the picture.
We don't know. See, we're having a crossover. We're having a crossover.
Just imagine Scott Frost.
See, yeah, why does it, now this comment came before we started talking about this game, but Andy says, Josh, don't say anything about the Cowboys. They suck. Did I miss, you know, we've been busy. We were doing stuff. Did something happen with the Cowboys?
No.
Did I miss any news with them in the last hour?
I don't think so.
And so Andy's just talking trash to me?
Yeah.
Screw
yeah.
you, Andy.
That just so happened.
Nobody likes
the Cowboys.
You, Andy.
Can you imagine if they did that same look
for Frost
or loss?
Yeah.
That would be incredible.
Good times.
I think they should do it. They should really consider it.
I agree.
And they have time for, put some Big Ten basketball games on whatever network they're going to put them on. Paramount Plus.
I do have that.
I don't think that's the one I don't have.
Do you have a
24/7 24/7 sports? Though,
yes, you
right?
do.
You don't subscribe to our good friends.
No, I do. So maybe I do have.
You just got to set it up.
Yeah, you just got to set it up.
Perfect. It's awesome. That's how I have it.
I have it. I have all the streaming services. I'm streaming man.
Yeah, I'll cape for that website. You subscribe to 24/7, you're good to go. You get a free subscription at Paramount Plus.
Yeah,
yeah,
it's a great deal.
Yeah, their app's pretty solid too.
It's a great deal.
Yeah,
you get Mike Schaefer. And you get Paramount Plus,
America's most watched network.
Indeed, we watched Jackass this summer with
we did
earlier this year.
We did. We've had a couple of movies off the Paramount.
We did the Bryan Cranston one recently. That
in
was
the movie
on Paramount.
Club.
Yep.
Yep.
Indeed.
They're gonna move. So they're gonna move the entire CBS broadcast, the SEC broadcast, over to the Big Ten. From what people are reporting.
Yep.
Hilarious.
Mm-hmm.
It's gonna be so weird.
Not surprising though.
No. I mean, it's good. It's good for the Big Ten. NBC, on the other hand, doesn't have anything to really offer us in terms of broadcasters at the moment.
Jason Garrett. This is unreal that is the best Notre Dame gets. Jason Garrett. Yep. And who? It's
they're
Chris Collinsworth's kid,
else.
Right?
Yeah.
That's who it is?
Jack.
Yeah, what are we doing?
Spelled J-A-C.
J-A-C.
Don't give them time. They might get good. You never know.
I hope they better. I'm not trying to watch no Jack Collinsworth and Jason Garrett.
I guess it just doesn't, you know.
Unless, Drew Brees is the other option.
Yeah. Gross. NBC, get it together.
It just doesn't bother me if it's, you know, the announcers don't bother
that's
me.
That's not true.
Okay, so, but that's the thing with NBC.
You?
Like,
announcers don't bother you?
No.
Every year when Nebraska gets a game with someone you don't like, you bitch about that.
Which one? Like who?
Herb Street.
Well, I'm not a big fan of Herb Street, but I won't turn the game
Beth
off because
Mullins.
Of him.
Ed Cunningham.
Beth Mullins Ed does Cunningham cup games. I'm used to Beth Mullins.
Yeah, but that doesn't mean you like her.
Well, yeah, I can complain about individual things that they've said.
Yeah.
But I'm not going to, I can't watch this game because Jack Collinsworth is on
it. No one's saying that. I'm just saying I wish they had better announcers.
Well, sure. Yeah. We all wish Vin Scully could be on every game, but he can't.
Well, he's dead.
I know.
He died.
I understand that, Josh.
Jeez, too soon.
I guarantee you this is what's going to happen. So before people, you know, pre-wring their hands, and NBC is going to go out. They're going to go and hire somebody from another network.
Yes,
they should get McDonough. See, I hope McDonough leaves.
They should.
Go to CBS or go to NBC. Let's get McDonough and Blackledge. They both used to work at CBS.
They're the best team ESPN has anyway.
Move on over to CBS. That'd be sweet.
Well, NBC. No, CBS is going to keep. They're going to keep their guys.
Yeah, if they're getting up there. Brad Nessler, I just included some of his highlights for 25 teams in 25 days. His voice is just, it's a bummer. It's shot. He just doesn't have the gravitas anymore.
Wow.
He doesn't.
Brad Nessler doesn't have gravitas.
No gravitas?
Listen to his voice. It's cracking. He sounds like a kid going through puberty.
I don't think gravitas has anything to do with it.
Isn't that he doesn't have the boom. That's what the word I'm looking for. Yeah.
I mean, he still probably walks into a room and people stop what they're doing and say,
do they stand
that man
up?
Has, that
All
man
rise.
Has gravitas. That man has gravitas.
I love Nessler. He was my favorite announcer for the longest time.
NBC will go out. They'll get, you know, because they're going to put they're going to put a lot into this.
They'll get an ESPN.
They'll get Jack Collinsworth other brother. That's who they'll get. Jason Garrett's son. Can't wait.
That's the thing. They could do whatever, you know, whatever they sort of want to do with it. However much they want to put into it, they can put into it. Mm-hmm. If they don't want to put anything into it, they don't have to.
They don't have to because they're paying the Big Ten a buku of money.
Yep.
That's where they'll save money.
And what is it, by the way? Is that the automatic path to instant television booth is you have to be a former Dallas Cowboys quarterback?
Dude, it pays pretty well, doesn't it?
I mean, where's Roger Staubach? How come he's
Quincy
not
Carter somewhere is like, well, I
Quincy
want to
Carter should be on there somewhere.
Chad Hutchinson.
Dak's got a Chad seat warm Hutchinson. For him whenever he quits.
He does. Yeah.
Kellen Moore, when he's not the OC anymore after he gets fired, he could be an
announcer. Kellen Moore wasn't a Cowboys quarterback.
He was.
He was?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Bad times. Remember. Brandon Whedon.
Ooh.
Yeah.
That's a fun one.
Yeah.
Yeah, what's Brandon Whedon up to? He's probably like 45 now.
How old is
he? No, he's not that old.
No, he's not that old.
You might be, I mean, decently close, though.
Brandon Whedon?
Wasn't Brandon Whedon one of those former baseball players?
Yes, he was 30 in his rookie year.
Well, that's still 7 years off.
Yeah.
That's a long way from 45.
It was a joke, but yeah.
Yeah, it's close.
Yeah.
It's close.
Mm-hmm.
Brandon Whedon's up to. All right. Yeah, well, I mean.
What's Brandon Whedon up to?
It's Googleable, right?
Yeah.
He's in line to get one of those NBC titles.
All right, let's see. Brandon Whedon. former quarterback, blah, blah, blah. What's he doing these days? His Wikipedia doesn't look like it says. Last time he played in the NFL was 2018. He has two sons. He's married. Cooper and Case. Wow, that definitely sounds like a Texan.
Hey, Case. That fits.
And Cooper.
Mm-hmm. Huh.
Here's my other child, Remington.
Carson.
Yeah, that's another one.
Cooper, Carson.
I would
and Case.
Like, you know how they do the breakdown of, Cade. You know, the most popular names in America. I would actually like to see it by state.
Oh yeah.
Cause I bet you probably hit on like at least top 25 names in Texas. All of those names you just said.
25 guaranteed. Names in 25 days.
Guaranteed. But
they're definitely top 25.
In Texas?
In Texas.
I bet half of the Texas quarterbacks are named Case.
Yeah.
Carson.
I remember
like
the first
high school
time,
quarterbacks.
Yeah.
The first time I saw Case Keenum written out, I thought it was Casey Keenum. That's how I was pronouncing right. it. And then I
Casey Kasem?
Yeah.
Casey
and, Kasem. Yeah, exactly. Casey Kasem.
Casey Kasem.
And I think I finally watched the game and I was like, it's Case?
Here's your long distance dedication. And big pass That's comes
pretty
in.
Good.
He has to. Now, that would be, if he wasn't dead, RIP, Casey Kasem would be good in the NBC booth.
Would he?
Yes.
Every long pass would be, at another long distance dedication.
Ah! When did he die?
A while ago now.
Oh, yeah, there's been he's got a Ted Williams thing going on.
Yeah,
his head's frozen.
They're fighting over his body.
Yeah, they're fighting over his remains.
Oh.
Which is always really smart and cool.
Yeah.
Hey, you know what I don't want people to do when I die is that. No fighting over my remains. I'm putting that in my will. No
Are
fighting
you gonna
over.
Disintegrate yourself?
Yes. Throw my ashes somewhere. No. Dump my ashes. Is John still alive? I want someone to come in and just dump them all over him during the crossover with whomever your new co-host is. When you're 98. That's what I want
There's
to have happen.
Josh's audio will.
Yeah.
Right here on the crossover.
Dump the ashes on John's carpet at home and make him vacuum me up.
My God.
But no, I want to. Yeah. Turn me into ashes. I'm not trying to have no body. I don't want someone
not trying to have no body.
I don't want no one to dig me up. That's weird.
Why would anyone dig you up?
You know, defecate. I don't know.
Why would anyone God. Bother to dig 6 feet down? Just
That's
to
that
get
guy
your...
who said Scott Frost should be fired.
I mean, you're the same. Yesterday we were telling folks, hey, you shouldn't be wearing, you know, going shirtless. The last thing they want to do is see your decomposed body. It's one thing to see you shirtless. It's another thing to see you decomposed.
It's very awesome to see me shirtless. Many say, like, well, I wish I could see you shirtless.
Might come, be folks on
come
their
to West
going.
Omaha at like 8 a.m. and you see me running.
You're running shirtless?
Oh yeah, of course. Gotta get my tan going on, man.
You gotta
man.
Wear a shirt, man.
Absolutely.
You don't get a tan at 8 a.m.
Yes, the sun is up at 8 Just, in the
but
morning.
But it's not high enough to do any good.
It's chilly. You running right now with your shirt off?
Oh,
it's
yeah.
chilly in the morning.
60 is perfect.
You have to
weather.
Wait until after like 10 or 11 in the morning.
How do you think I got this color on me?
Put
Look
a
all that
shirt
color.
On, Josh.
Absolutely.
My God.
Us runners.
Oh, oh my God.
We don't wear shirts.
Us runners don't wear shirts.
We don't, unless it's a race. I'll wear shirts.
I see people running with shirts all the
yeah.
time.
Look, I got nothing to hide here. I'm not a, you know, feeling bad about my body. I mean, I am that. I run for fun. We've talked about this. I'm a psycho.
You said it.
At least I own up to
Yeah,
it.
You got
to
put a shirt on, man.
Absolutely not. I'll tweet that out. Josh, if you're still watching, which he usually is,
mm-hmm.
should Josh wear a shirt? That should be the poll
question.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Jed, trust me, Josh shirtless looks like a decomposing body.
Nailed it.
He's seen me running many times shirtless.
People think it's a zombie.
Yeah. All right, guys. We'll see you later.
There it is.
Wow, that was a crossover.
We covered some ground.
That was weird.
Yeah, it was.
I don't even know if we should say Happy New Year.
Nah, we're good.
Oh, so. Wow. Cody saw Josh running Saturday, and I agree. He needs a shirt.
Put a shirt on, man.
Maybe Cody, did you wave top? At me? I wonder if Cody waved at me. There's a few listeners I've
yeah,
run into.
Yeah, probably did. Probably said, get off the street, you jackass.
I don't.
This is for cars.
I don't run on the street, John. I'm a path boy. Roy says no shirt team here. Look at that.
Put a shirt on, Royce.
Yeah, put a shirt on, all of you.
Nope.
No one needs to see you with your shirt.
Mustache Adam. John Bishop, the authority on tanning. Yeah, you're not the guy I'm going to take advice from with the tan.
Listen,
there, John.
Sunburn, tan, it's all in the same family. You're not getting tan at 8 o'clock in the morning unless you're going to a tanning booth.
When the sun is up, I definitely am getting that sun on my body.
No, it's got to be higher in the atmosphere. It's got to be higher up.
Don't think that's how it works. I've gotten sunburned.
That is how it works.
I think that is how it works.
I've gotten sunburned in the morning.
Yeah, it was probably, you know, after 10-ish or so.
No, it was before 9.
Well, that's probably because
How do you know?
That's what I run. I always run before 9.
You probably poured gasoline and just lit yourself on fire.
Well, I mean, maybe. Look, sometimes my Saturdays, I got to spice them up a little bit. Sometimes.
All right. Happy New Year's Eve.
Happy New Year's. Yeah, you know what? Screw it. Yeah, mark this one there, yeah, Conrad. Yeah. Happy New Year from us.
Happy New Year.
Conrad's like, what are you talking about?
Yeah, he has no idea what's going on.
It's all right.
We'll just skip this one.
We're just going to skip it and pretend like these last. We're going to Bobby Ewing this. We're just going to pretend it was all a dream. It didn't happen.
Sounds
when
good
we come back, it's a program.
Awesome.
And we'll be reading articles all day long from the Irish Times.
I thought that was a good column.
Oh, my God.
And on that note, 1620 The Zone.
Irrational confidence.
I want to go back to the original situation. The plane is fine. Everything about the plane is fine, except for the pilot is no longer able to fly the plane. And I am the only person left in a working, usable plane that has no technical issues.
But you can land that plane?
I can land that plane.
Irrational confidence. The Connor Happer Show. Weekdays from 10 to 2 on 1620. The Zone. Your Omaha area forecast from the Godfather's Pizza Weather Center and KETV News Watch 7 on 1620 The Zone.
Partly sunny and warm Thursday. Southwest wind between 5 and 15 miles per hour. Dry through the afternoon, then a chance for a few isolated showers and storms closer to sunset. Highs in the mid-80s. I'm meteorologist Sean Everson from KETV News Watch 7.
1620 The Zone's Unsportsmanlike Conduct, brought to you by a great friend of the program, Union Bank and Trust.
The Ford truck lineup is purpose-built from the ground up, designed to be tough and productive. Crafted with high-strength, military-grade aluminum alloy body and torture-tested high-strength steel frame with new tech to help you work smart and hard. The F-150, Ranger, and Maverick are built tough and ready to tackle whatever lies ahead. Hit the road in confidence and learn more about Ford trucks in-store or online anytime at WoodhouseFord.com, your trusted truck dealer since 1975. Woodhouse Ford.
Ted Wally's. Squeeze every last bit of flavor out of summer than you can with a spoonful of creamy, delicious Ted Wally's Ultra Premium Ice Cream. If you're in Benson, swing in for pints, quarts, or half gallons of Ted Wally's to take home. Or if you're in the old market, taking your senior photos or maybe just kind of hanging out, slip into Ted Wally's for a tasty treat after the photo session. There's still plenty of summer left. Enjoy it with rich, creamy flavors of Ted Wally's Ultra Premium Ice Cream in Benson, the Old Market, and at TedWally's.com.
Fantasy football isn't just a game. It's a way of life. And with the NFL Fantasy app, your life just got way better. Get all the touchdowns, fantasy points, and bragging rights all in one place. It's free and easy to play. Just sign up and draft. Optimize your lineup with one click and watch exclusive player stories from the stars you know to sleepers who can win you your league. NFL Fantasy. We live for this. Download the NFL Fantasy app today.
You've been putting back a few, and a few becomes a few too many. For a moment, you think of calling for a ride, but nah, you live nearby. What's the worst that could happen? You get pulled over, your insurance goes up, you lose your license, you total your car, you kill someone. The results of driving drunk are tragic. That's why law enforcement is out there looking for impaired drivers to save lives. So if you think you're okay to drive after a few drinks, think again. Drive sober or get pulled over. Paid for by NHTSA.
I always wanted to learn Spanish, but I never thought I'd have the time. Then I discovered Babbel.
Babbel's lessons are fun. They only take like 10 or 15 minutes, and in 3 weeks, presto, you're speaking another language. Like magic.
I love that Babbel's lessons aren't just robots talking. They're voiced by native speakers, so you get the pronunciation just right. And they're designed by real language teachers, so you learn how to have real-world conversations, things you'll actually use.
3 weeks. It's incredible. After 3 weeks, I'm on vacation in Paris, having a conversation in French.
There's all kinds of ways to learn. Use Babbel's podcasts or games or videos. You can even join live classes with a language teacher.
If you want to learn a language, there's no faster, easier, better way than
Babbel.
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 Babbel. Évidemment.
Go to Babbel.com to try for free. That's Babbel.com. Babbel.com.
Dingman's Collision Center, Omaha's top choice for over 20 years. Your safety is our number one priority.
this edition of Unsportsmanlike Conduct on 1620 The Zone is proudly presented by Union Bank and Trust. The program starts now.
KOZN. Unsportsmanlike Conduct on 1620 The Zone. Husker Athletics, Creighton, and yes, UNL. Don't miss a moment, they'll give you your fix. They're on every day from 2 until 6. Spend your afternoons with John, Josh, and Nick. John, Josh, and Nick. Show you what sports talk really is.
Here's the part where you can bring it down a little bit, because we talk over this part.
We do. We say words.
And then we say the program is coming up next here on 1620 The Zone at 1620thezone.com.
It's indeed coming up next.
On Sportsmanlike Conduct on 1620 The Zone. Husker Athletics, Creighton, and yes, you went up.
See, that's how you backseat produce.
Yeah, that was pretty condescending there for me, John.
No, it wasn't. Now it's too loud. It's too loud.
He turned our mics off. What are you doing? What's going on here?
It's off.
Now that's producing. He was like, you know what? Screw you guys. You're making fun of me. Click.
Click.
You're off.
Yeah. What was the term we used to give all the substitute producers back in the Stibs days?
Fill in Stibs.
Fill in Stibs.
Fill in Stibs.
Fill in Nick.
Fill in Nick. Yeah, you know what I'm learning about the Fill in Nicks? They don't listen to the show.
That's all right.
I don't think they're no, that's fine. No, I don't think they're fans
you don't
of
have,
us.
You don't have to.
Yeah, yeah.
It's not that
I mean,
important.
I wouldn't.
We don't practice what we do anyway.
Jim and O'Neill texts in. The shirt to no shirt ratio for runners is like 100 to 1. Shirtless runners are almost always the dudes who wear bandanas. I don't wear a bandana, but I do wear a headband. I found that's
no
the
problem.
Best.
I have no problem with a headband. That keeps the sweat out of your eyes.
Thank you. Thank you.
Well, that's what a headband does.
That's correct. That's why I wear one. I wear fun ones. They have fun
that'd
graphics.
That'd be like
on
saying,
it.
You know, a gas cap is to keep the gas in your gas tank.
Yeah, that's true. Good call.
It's a good thing you have one.
I do like having a gas cap.
Because if you don't, you'll get the little check engine light because the pressurization in the.
Oh, that's not good.
It's not working. You don't have to worry about that with an electric car.
That's true. Well, you still have to. Oh, you're talking like all electric.
Well, yeah, they don't have gas caps in electric cars.
People forget
that.
They do indeed.
Coming up on the program today, brought to you by the Rooferies, John Higgins Weather Guard, Ravi Lulla, Robin Washut. Will Johnson will be along to talk about Texas A&M
and
Mitch Holtis.
The Chiefs.
Chiefs training camp update. And maybe at some point we'll see if we can bring in Dave Hannigan of the Irish Times.
That guy decided to set Nebraska on fire, and I wonder how many.
This is an interesting story.
How many clicks he has received from the 402, from the 308?
Oh, a lot.
And then whatever the other area.
Yeah,
code
whatever
is
that
in
was.
Omaha.
It 541 or something.
514 maybe.
That goofy,
yeah,
you know, yeah, extra
new
area
code.
That we get.
I don't like that.
Though anymore, because you take your phone number with you.
Yeah.
You know, like people who move here from other states.
Yeah, they still have the old ones.
They still have their old area code.
Mm-hmm.
So what's the point of area codes anymore? Yeah, what's the point of area codes anymore?
Mm-hmm.
There's really not a point to it.
I mean there's,
there's a point in that you still have to have.
Well, it's just where
you
got your phone originally.
The digits.
Yeah, because you'd run out of numbers. Yeah.
Right, but it used to be a way you could identify, hey, this person is definitely from.
Well, yeah, now it's how you identify where they are from, not maybe where,
or
they're
where they
currently
bought their phone.
Correct. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Mine's
got their initial phone number.
Mine's 402. I hope that I have this phone number for the rest of my life. I hope that I don't have to get a different one.
I don't think you should have to.
Yeah, well, unless
I
do.
I think you can take your number with you.
Yeah, that's true.
Wherever you go.
Yeah, and it's still AM radio.
It is. Dave Hannigan, a product of the 212.
Is that what they are, the 212?
Well,
plus 44, though. Don't forget about that.
He's New York based, but he's writing for the Irish Times.
Oh, really? Oh, I thought he was over there. What's his name? Dave Hannigan?
Yeah.
Dave Hannigan.
You want to know more about Dave?
I really don't.
Well, it says Dave Hannigan, contributor. He's a contributor to the Irish Times based in New York.
Okay. Is it this guy? Is that him on Twitter? Yep, there's a picture of Ireland. So it's probably this guy.
It could be.
It's probably this guy.
It could be.
He triggered everybody today.
He did.
You know what I thought when I read that story?
Well, you just said you...
Look, did I like it? No. I thought the truth hurts sometimes. That's what I thought. Reading.
Well, yeah, the truth does hurt.
So why are people mad? Because the truth hurts so much that you get mad.
What is the point of bringing up all of that stuff?
I mean, Nebraska's going overseas, so he's probably like,
that doesn't mean that these transgressions are coming with them.
Well, he probably just doesn't like it. He probably doesn't like the series. I don't know. Why do people do what they do? You know, he probably had to write. His editors are probably
not,
like, hey, we want you to write about this.
Not
he was
to
like,
do the whole cable news whataboutism, but. Yeah. I'm sure there's some transgressions in Northwestern's past. Why not write about those?
Because Northwestern is not a big football brand like Nebraska. That's what I figured.
They're coming over too. Yeah, well, it takes two to tango.
Maybe the follow-up column's coming tomorrow.
But what would be the point? That's my question.
Editor probably was like, hey, we want you to write about this. You know, he's probably not a football fan. He's probably like, I don't know. Okay,
well,
let me see what I can write about. He did a lot of research.
He knew where to look for the juicy stuff.
Yeah, I don't know.
I mean, the fact that he led off with the Maurice Washington. I mean, if you think about the history.
That's the thing. He went deep on like all these random things.
If you think about all the long history of Nebraska coaches, mostly athletes, who've gotten in trouble with the law or have done things to embarrass the institution. Mm-hmm. Embarrass the fans, embarrass their family, embarrass themselves. The Maurice Washington one is kind of low on the list. Mm-hmm. And that's not,
but it's the most recent of all of them.
Yeah. And by most recent, it's still 4 years ago, you know. But yeah, the fact that he led off with the Maurice Washington, and let's see, then he went, I mean, here's the paragraph. You know, he writes about Washington, and of course it was Scott Frost's decision to play Washington. Frost is the character leading the Cornhuskers into Dublin to take on the Northwestern University Wildcats at the Aviva Stadium. I think that's how you say it, next week. If Aer Lingus and the litany of other corporate sponsors involved in this shindig wanted to give Irish sports fans a taste of the authentic college football experience in all its exploitative, chew these young men up and spit most of them out glory, they have chosen wisely.
See, that's the thing. My guess is this is a guy who doesn't want this coming over. He probably hates college football.
Well,
he hates what it stands for.
He's in New York. He shouldn't care if it's going over there. He doesn't have to look at it.
He's probably an Irish person. He writes for the Irish Times. Again,
but
he's writing about it
New
from
York.
The angle of, though, the newspaper. He's writing about it from the angle of Irish folk.
Yeah, I'm sure there are a lot of Irish folk who's really concerned about
it. I'm guessing that a whole lot of them
By the way,
don't care.
Did you notice the
dislike it?
Did you notice the subtle little Irish touch he put on the article when referencing back to the Lawrence Phillips Kate McEwen story?
No, I don't think so.
Lawrence Phillips, then Nebraska's best running back, broke into Frost's apartment and dragged his own ex-girlfriend, Katie McEwen, down three flights of stairs. I've never seen her referred to as Katie.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I guess I didn't think of that as being an Irish
Katie
thing.
McEwen.
Oh, okay. I was like,
oh, drag her down the stairs, you know.
Okay, stop.
That's Lawrence Phillips.
Don't do it. Don't say, anytime you talk in that accent, it makes me want to laugh. And you're talking about a very serious event right
now. Well, it
is. So don't do it. Don't talk about it
but
in that accent.
But that's how an Irish person would read it.
Yes, but you're not Irish.
Phillips served a 6-game suspension, but was back on the field for the business end of the campaign to help them win a national championship, of course. He even got in, and I didn't even know this one. I didn't even know this one.
I didn't know it was Frost's house. Did you know that or his apartment?
His apartment, yeah.
I had no idea it was his apartment.
Yeah, I knew it was. Yeah, it was his apartment.
Okay.
The university is currently on probation for violating NCAA rules last year. Frost himself is waiting to serve a 5-day ban this season for his part in that debacle. And the newly arrived offensive coordinator. By the way, coordinator is spelled co-ordinator.
That's how they talk in Ireland, maybe.
Coordinator Mark Hohippel was suspended from a previous job for comparing a foul committed against one of his players to rape.
Stop saying it in this accent.
I didn't know he got in trouble for doing that, for comparing something that happened on the field to rape. Did you know that?
I heard about that recently. I heard about that.
By reading it in the Irish Times.
Not about that. I believe it was surrounded with the I think it was the Pitt podcast thing. I think that's when I learned about it. So within the last month.
And then he goes
look,
into
here's a, okay.
And then he goes into the whole point about, well, there's going to be a pep rally. There's going to be cheerleaders. And he says, but here's hoping that Ron Brown takes the microphone at some point. And then he goes on to describe how Ron Brown once testified at a Lincoln City Council meeting.
Yeah, he roasted old Ronnie.
On an LGBTQ plus policy that was being debated.
You know why I wasn't critical of this thing? Because when they hired Ron Brown, I essentially said the same thing on the show and on social media. Like, are we sure that this is a good move to hire him?
Right, but again, just the point that he's dragging all of this stuff out.
Oh, Dan makes the same joke you did earlier. Surprised he didn't bring up Johnny Rogers robbing a liquor store.
Oh, yeah.
Joe says, I looked him up and saw some of his previous stuff. Nebraska fans shouldn't take it personally. He wrote a scathing article about inequality in Augusta, Georgia, and the problematic past of the Masters 2 days before the tournament. This is just what he does, stirs the pot for clicks. A lot of people, I don't know, I don't view it as stirring the pot. I view it as...
Oh, he's absolutely, of course he's stirring the pot.
But I mean, he's also probably playing to his base. His base is probably like, yeah, this is stupid.
His base are easily angered Irish folk?
People don't like America and a lot of the things we stand for. And college football might be exhibit A in some of the wrongs, but obviously I love college football, but you know how it is.
I do, but I mean, that would...
John, it'd be like you, right? If let's say the World Cup comes to Omaha and you get on the air and you decide to just rip into FIFA. It's the same thing. It's the exact same thing. He's playing to his base. Why is that wrong? To play to, again, who is reading you or who is... If you feel that way about FIFA, why am I going to get on and be like, John, I can't believe you're being so critical of FIFA. We should be happy to have the World Cup in Omaha.
Here's the difference. Here would be the difference in that circumstance, right? FIFA is currently engaging in activity to...
Oh, they're a very bad group.
Yeah.
They're a very bad
group. To exploit countries and exploit, you know workers and things of that nature.
Sure.
So that they can build these... expensive stadiums.
People die.
And they've done some terrible things and they're still doing those things. Now, granted, Ron Brown is still a member of the team. Frost is still a member of the team.
Yeah.
Whipple. But I don't know. I think it's dragging stuff up just for the point of dragging stuff up. Listen, if this is what he wants to do, I'm not telling him he can't do it.
What am I going to say?
But
don't have it's that also, opinion.
It also just seemed like a really, really weird thing to write about. That's all. Just seemed like a really weird and probably unnecessary thing to write about. Because, yeah, sure, these things are true. You could have looked them all up yourself. And I'll give him credit, man. He did
his research.
He went, like I said, I had no idea that
was Frost's apartment. No idea.
He Googled Nebraska Cornhusker controversies on the old Google machine, and I'm just, if this were a term paper, though, I would cite him for lack of,
citations?
Is it citations?
Like you're talking about, like, are you, like,
yeah,
a,
at the
like
end,
the bibliography?
Where you have to, you put the little, the little A, and then taken from the Lincoln Journal Star, October 17th, 2018.
In all seriousness, I'd love to know where he did all... I mean, he was right about all
Googled
the stuff.
He Googled it.
Yeah, he did a really good job. He Googled. Probably subscribed to a couple spots.
So there you go. Another reason why Scott Frost shouldn't go over there. Yesterday,
he's like,
projectile
guys,
vomiting.
I don't want to go.
They're dragging us through the mud. You know what? I'm actually going to take responsibility for this article.
You're going to...
I don't think Dave had intentions of looking all of this up until he heard yesterday's program and our bashing of boiled bacon and cabbage.
People...
And he took offense to it and said, fine, I'll show those Nebraska idiots.
Those stupid Americans say that our breakfast is bad and people will vomit. Spot the lie, though, Dave.
I think
you don't like our sport. We don't like your food.
I think that's what happened. Mm-hmm. I think we're responsible for this article being written.
Yeah. Zachary says, in 2019, a Northwestern recruit, Aiden Atkinson, was arrested on sexual assault charges. In 2017, a football player was arrested on felony drug charges for cocaine. In 1998, four former football players were charged with point shaving and throwing football games. So I believe that's what you call whataboutism.
Sure, it is.
Again, my guess is he was he's writing about Nebraska because it's Nebraska, you know, because they won championships.
Because they don't care about you, Northwestern.
Northwestern did all this illegal stuff. Also, they suck, you know, like just the angle is just a little less. Josh says, how do you say spot the lie in Irish? Say spot the lie.
Spot the lie.
Spot the lie.
I'm sure they have like a cute little colloquialism, you know.
Oh, like a phrase?
Yeah, a different phrase.
Text message from the 402, an unnamed person says, Josh Peterson here for bad journalism. This is his opinion.
This isn't.
It's a column.
Okay, we should make.
He did do journalism and research.
He did journalism and research.
But this is an editorial.
Yeah, this is an editorial. This is not.
This is like, okay, here you go. You ready for an
opinion? This is not a here's the facts story.
Yeah.
This is an opinion piece.
Correct.
Which does have to, if it's a good opinion, or it's a well thought out opinion, whether you agree with it or not, has to contain facts.
Which it did. Yeah.
Yeah, that's true.
You can disagree.
Nothing in there. You're right to your point. There's nothing in there that is erroneous. Mm-hmm. All of those things happen.
Yeah, he nailed it. Yeah, he nailed it.
Just show. Damn you, Google.
Yeah.
If it weren't for Google, he would have never known.
Yeah, he'd have
we could have hidden all of our
transgressions.
We could have hidden all that stuff. Mm-hmm. I'm just upset. That Eric Crouch's ham sandwich didn't end up. Because that, to me, still is the greatest scandal in Nebraska football
history. Ha, Jeffrey. People get mad when we bring up championships 25 years ago. So should we get mad for bringing this up? Yeah, hey, if you don't want Husker fans to live in the 90s, our transgressions can't live in the 90s.
That's a great idea.
Keep them in the 90s. I mean, he did write about some recent ones, too. But keep the old ones in the 90s.
Dave wants me to continue reading the article in an Irish accent.
David says, oh, get off it, Josh. I've been to Ireland 3 times and they don't hate Americans, and most don't hate American football either. You know, you just want to click. I bet it's like the New York Post of Ireland. Nice. That's funny. I'm sure people over there hate college football.
Actually, it'd be more like the Trimes.
The Trimes?
The Post is big football, right? I mean, the Post is more.
Well, he's saying like the Post being, you know, about that type of journalism of like back page, like that type of idea.
Sure. But this would be in a kind of an opinion that might end up in the Trimes.
I'm guessing that people over there dislike. I'm not saying that everyone hates America. I'm just saying some of them probably dislike what college football stands for. There are people in America who don't like what college football stands for. Unpaid labor, you know, the sport.
You could probably count the people that are native-born Irish who are overly concerned about
They probably don't
the
think
rights of college athletes on one hand.
Yeah, they probably don't think about
they
it.
They don't care.
They probably hear about it and they're like, that's weird. That's probably their opinion. Wait, what? You know, like, there was this video, and I know we're way past time, but there was this video of this Englishman, and he went to, I think, an Iron Bowl. I know he went to an Auburn football game. He couldn't believe that this was college. He was like, these aren't professionals? He couldn't believe it. The number of people to there to watch amateurs, and he was stunned.
They are still, well, now they're doing heating and air conditioning spots, so technically they're not amateurs anymore. All right, Robin, Texas A&M. The Big Ten's big deal.
Yeah, we got to talk about this.
Coming up all here. On 1620 The Zone.
You could win $5,000 to have the ultimate tailgate party on 1620 The Zone. Enter now at 1620thezone.com.
Hey friends, Kent Pavelka here, back with John Higgins and the Rooferies at the Weather Guard Showroom. I imagine there are a lot of people out there with really bad roofs waiting for the magic moment. When's the magic moment?
Depends on what type of roof you have. It depends on how old your roof is. I have a customer right now talking about waiting for that hailstorm. Now it's leaking. There's a time where you can't wait for that hailstorm forever.
When it comes time to replace your roof, your gutters, and siding, there's only one call to make. The Rooferies at John Higgins Weather Guard.
Hi guys, it's Andrew with Brookside Medical Clinic. Is erectile dysfunction damaging your relationship? Are you sick of the pill and all the side effects? Well, welcome to the future. We have a major medical breakthrough. Brookside Medical Clinic uses the most advanced form of wave therapy. Backed by 60 clinical studies, our technology uses pressure waves to repair and open up blood vessels. We've helped countless men get rid of their ED. But what is the true end result? Their relationship, even their lives, improved drastically. If you're ready to regain your love life, call us right now, and not only will the assessment and ultrasound be free, we'll also give you a gift that produces immediate results in the bedroom. It almost never fails. This is worth $550, and it's free to callers right now. 402-671-7777. That's 402-671-7777. Put a stop to your erectile dysfunction and experience what I call the happiness ripple effect. Call Brookside Medical Clinic now. 402-671-7777.
Don't miss this week's Zone Deal.
This week's half-off deal is $50 worth of vouchers to Le Voltaire French Restaurant for only $25. Le Voltaire Pepperwood Village is a locally owned, unpretentious French restaurant serving down-home cooking with an extensive wine list and great handcrafted cocktails for decades. Whether dining with friends, clients, or that special someone, Le Voltaire will make you feel right at home.
Zone deals go fast. 9 a.m. Friday, 1620thezone.com.
Do you have big plans for your business? Get access and get growing. If you need a commercial loan or line of credit, the experts at Access Bank can help you get financing that fits your dreams. We're dedicated to supporting owners and entrepreneurs like you on a timeline that fits your schedule, because we're here for a reason, to help Omaha grow. Get started today at accessbank.com. That's accessbank.com. Member FDIC.
Hi, everybody. Gary Sharp. You know, if you've been in Nebraska for a while and you love going to sporting events and you're getting your hands on the best tickets, there's a good chance you bought them from Ticket Express. Well, I'm here to tell you that Ticket Express has a new name. It's Tickets for Less. So if you've loved the quality customer service and the community feel that Ticket Express has brought us over the past three decades, have no fear. Tickets for Less is going to be here with the same energy and the same selection. Ticketsforless.com. Always the best seats at the best prices to your favorite sporting events. And if you ever need anything, just give them a call. 402-398-1999 and tell them Gary sent you.
Hi guys, it's Andrew with Brookside Medical Clinic. Is erectile dysfunction damaging your relationship? Are you sick of the pill and all the side effects? Well, welcome to the future. We have a major medical breakthrough. Brookside Medical Clinic uses the most advanced form of wave therapy. Backed by 60 clinical studies, our technology uses pressure waves to repair and open up blood vessels. We've helped countless men get rid of their ED. But what is the true end result? Their relationship, even their lives, improved drastically. If you're ready to regain your love life, call us right now, and not only will the assessment and ultrasound be free, we'll also give you a gift that produces immediate results in the bedroom. It almost never fails. This is worth $550, and it's free to callers right now. 402-671-7777. That's 402-671-7777. Put a stop to your erectile dysfunction and experience what I call the happiness ripple effect. Call Brookside Medical Clinic now. 402-671-7777.
Today on Hey Culligan, soft water, cleaner environment. What do you say, Greg?
Hey Culligan, are you saying if I have a Culligan high-efficiency water softener, I'm also helping the environment?
It sounds like you're saying it, Greg, and yes, you are, because with the Culligan high-efficiency water softener, you'll use less detergent, soap, and harsh chemicals, and that's good for the planet.
Now you're saying it.
You bet I am, Greg. Soft water and a cleaner environment is already on the way. Let us help you out with a free in-home water test from a local Culligan water expert at Culligan.com.
Ted and Wally's. Squeeze every last bit of flavor out of summer than you can with a spoonful of creamy, delicious Ted and Wally's Ultra Premium Ice Cream. If you're in Benson, swing in for pints, quarts, or half gallons of Ted and Wally's to take home. Or if you're in the old market, taking your senior photos or maybe just kind of hanging out, slip into Ted and Wally's for a tasty treat after the photo session. There's still plenty of summer left. Enjoy it with rich, creamy flavors of Ted and Wally's Ultra Premium Ice Cream in Benson, the Old Market, and at tedandwallys.com.
Your neighborhood is more than blocks of buildings. It's the people who live there that make it special. At Union Bank and Trust, we're not just creating home loans. We're making neighbors. We're not just small business lenders. We're small business shoppers. We don't just live in your community. We help you build it. Because our people are your people. Visit ubt.com/neighbor to learn more. Union Bank and Trust, member FDIC.
Since 1977, Septemberfest, the annual salute to labor, delivers fun to the entire family, from musical acts in the beer garden, entertainment for children in the kiddie kingdom, to a giant carnival midway. Septemberfest also offers an amazing variety of food and attractions like MMA fighting and boxing. Proceeds from Septemberfest fund a number of community improvement projects. For more details on Septemberfest's philanthropy and this year's September 2nd through the 5th jam-packed event schedule at CHI Center Lot D, go to septemberfestomaha.org.
Shop Woodhouse Place Hyundai and Nissan, 144th and Giles, KOZN Bellevue, Omaha, Council Bluffs.
Gary, I'd love to read your email because he used a lot of Irishisms.
Oh, nice.
But unfortunately, there's too much.
Well, here, I'll read this one then. Zach says, I didn't get Gary's email. Oh, wait. Oh, yeah, I did. Never mind. Zach writes, this isn't a Rubik's Cube. Non-local media put out stories like this because they know how thin-skinned Nebraska fans are. Stories like this lead to high number of clicks and interactions from whining Nebraska fans. It's not a Rubik's Cube.
I didn't say it was a Rubik's Cube.
We are very good at clicking. We love reading stories. I wasn't going to read it at first.
But I think any fan base would react this way.
Definitely.
Yes, are Nebraska fans thin-skinned? Of course they are. But many fans are. If this would have been about Iowa.
Well, and here's the thing.
They'd have written about what Iowa had happened to them a couple of years ago.
Yeah, you know what? If Penn State was playing in this game, I'm guessing I know which angle this guy would have taken. And that's his right. It's his again. It's his opinion. You know, I'm trying to think of. It's hard to think of like a corollary because I really don't. I wouldn't objectively get angry if there was like a certain sport coming to Omaha.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I mean, like the World Cup. Even the World Cup. I want to go to the World Cup, but I also understand that the FIFA has a lot of ills to it. But I still want to go. I'm going to try to go when it's in America in a few years.
And I'm going to bash you. And
exactly. And look at you supporting FIFA. You know, like if Liv came here, I'd make fun of it. But yeah. I wouldn't, you know, I don't.
Wait till they find out that Nebraska is joining the Liv Tour.
Mm.
By the way, speaking of golf, legitimate, good, fun, enjoyable, non-exploitative golf. Tomorrow's Golf Flash will be there, and guess what?
Oh, sold out, baby!
She is sold out.
Sold out.
We have a sellout streak. Did we? How many have we sold?
I think we sold all five of them out.
We need
even
to find
the COVID
out.
Year. We didn't have cardboard
sure.
cutouts.
We need to have a find out for sure because I want to make sure that's on the press release for next year. That we have a five-game sellout streak. But yes, we'll be at Miracle Hill. Doesn't mean you can't still show up. You could, you know, jump in the old Top Tracer building.
That's
or
true.
Just come by and grab a beer or two out of the clubhouse and come join us. We'll be broadcasting all day long. We will be live at Miracle Hill just off of, is it 114
just north of Dodge on 120th Street?
Yeah,
Miracle
right.
Hill Golf and Tennis.
Yeah, 120th and Dodge. Just turn north.
Yep.
And it's just on the other side of the hill crest.
You'll see it.
And it'll be fun and we'll have a great time. So looking forward to yet another Golf Flash tomorrow. Sadly, Nick won't be with us, so we'll have to find someone else to do the ceremonial tee shot.
That's true. You're a producer on site, right? Maybe you could be Conrad.
Yeah, but do you have a golf shot that's as ugly as Nick?
That's true. That's too bad.
A swing that's as hideous as that.
I have never played golf other than mini golf.
There we go. Honorary tee shot.
Honorary tee shot.
Let's go.
Tomorrow. But first, we need to talk to our friend, Mr. Lulla.
Ravi Lulla.
He talks basketball on 1620 The Zone. His name's Ravi Lulla, and he's on the phone. Ravi Lulla. Ravi Lulla. He is here to talk Creighton basketball.
Did you see what Dave wrote on the YouTube page? Red carpet golf flash. No red carpet experience here.
Nope. The kids aren't allowed.
Stay away, kids. You're in school. Get back to school.
I shouldn't say they're not allowed. I mean, kids are allowed at Miracle Hill Golf and Tennis, but there are no minors that we know of that are registered to be playing.
Yeah, I don't think so, yeah.
In the golf flash. I don't know if there is an age limit. Is there an age limit on the golf flash?
I don't believe so.
I don't think there is.
Nope.
Well, either way, we're drinking beer, so definitely you gotta be 21 or older
to drink beer.
To participate in that phase of golf flash. Hello, Ravi.
Ravi.
What's going on, fellas?
Living the dream, man. Living the dream.
Are you okay? You gonna make it?
Yeah. I think so.
Okay. Usually living the dream is code for I want to kill myself. So
No, I'm happy. No, I'm doing well, Robbie. Okay. I'm doing well.
I don't think I've ever heard.
That's like the white person's cry for help. I was just checking.
I'm doing good.
I've never heard that.
I do not say it unironically. I say it unironically.
I mean, I've heard some people use it ironically, but I've always equated it with people in good moods more than bad moods.
Maybe I was spending too much time with your producer. Then that might be it.
Yeah, Nick is definitely someone who, he says living the dream, he wants to bash his head into the table.
Please, Ravi, don't let Nick represent our people.
All the whites. Don't let Nick represent all us whites. Yeah, that's a good call.
He's a little different.
Yeah, that's true.
He's a little different. We'll get to some football in a second, but yesterday we learned that Roddy Andronikashvili is leaving the Creighton program. He's going to go back to Europe and play professionally. Who benefits most from this departure?
You mean as far as who's left on the roster?
Yes.
That's a good question. I hadn't really thought about it in those terms. I would say probably either... Francisco Farabello or Ben Stolzberg gives them a little more opportunity to earn some minutes at that point guard spot. That's a pretty crowded backcourt right now. So I kind of understand, from Roddy's perspective, you're looking at it, you're like, what are we looking at as far as playing time here? If I've got some other opportunities, might be time to take advantage of those. But yeah, I would say one of those two guys, probably either Farabello or Stolzberg, who gets a chance to maybe get more point guard minutes or even off guard minutes than they might have had a chance to with Roddy still in the rotation there.
So what are you surprised, I guess, Ravi, August, what we learned this yesterday, right? The 17th,
yep.
that there was still kind of news, I guess, to be had with the roster. I guess, you think we're all done now?
Yeah, I mean, I would imagine we're done now. With classes having officially started, that obviously makes it more challenging. I'm surprised by the timing a little bit, I guess. I'm not surprised by the move itself. I'd been hearing all the way back to the end of last season that it seemed unlikely that both Sharif and Roddy would return. Obviously Sharif was still wanted to be here, still committed to the program. So just from a minute standpoint, there was kind of a logjam there. Now I didn't know if that meant that Roddy would, transfer elsewhere and try and continue playing college with his connections back in Europe. That part of it makes sense also. So I'm not surprised by the move in general. I'm a little surprised by the timing of it happening so late in the summer.
Well, and you mentioned Sharif Mitchell, and, obviously he was able to make his bones when he was able to play as a premium defender. And Roddy had kind of, dare I say, kind of moved into a poor man's version of that role with some of his performances, particularly late in the season. So it would seem that, they kind of played a similar position and they kind of played a similar role with the team. And obviously Reef wants to expand his offensive game as well. So I would think, this kind of clears up a little bit of a logjam, at least from that standpoint.
Yeah, the only difference there for me is Roddy, with his size, does have the ability to maybe play off ball in a way that Sharif really doesn't.
Right.
He's 6'4", pretty good size, especially for a young kid in Roddy. So, you can move him to the two. Not that there's a ton of minutes to be had there either. You can even move him to a three and kind of a smaller lineup. So he had a little bit more positional versatility with Roddy, but in terms of what they were bringing to the table as their primary skill, last year Roddy really did make his name as, and surprisingly really, as somebody you can kind of throw out there and give another team a little bit of hell on the defensive end of the floor. Obviously the Marquette game comes to mind, where he kind of single-handedly kept that one for the Jays with a couple of late defensive possessions. But obviously Sharif brings a lot of that same. Well, the big difference to me is just the size and therefore the positional versatility. The disappointing thing about Roddy leaving at this point for me is just that I think there was a lot more to his game than we saw last year. I know Mac reined him in a lot to try and kind of get him used to a different style and a different role over here at Creighton. But I think there was a lot more to his game offensively than we ever really got to see But I'm just a little bit bummed that we're never going to see that here.
Ravi, kind of using hoops as a jumping off point into the news of the day with the Big Ten Conference. I wonder how you viewed it through the prism of basketball, because whenever we talk about, you know, all of the television contract stuff, of course, it's based around football, and we know how much football matters and how much it drives the bus. And then you kind of read and you sift through the news of today, and it looks like a lot of Big Ten games are going to be moving on to Peacock. Gone are they going to be from ESPN? I guess when you see these types of things, I wonder what you think it could mean for the Big East, for Creighton, and I guess for just men's college basketball in general moving forward.
Yeah, I mean, for a conference first and really only in terms of our conference play like the Big East is, it's going to be really interesting to see what the financial disparities really do in terms of if they create a larger gap or not. Let's be honest, though, there was already a huge financial gap between the Creighton, Butler, Xaviers of the world and the, you know, Florida, Alabama, Kentucky's of the world from a financial standpoint, right? So it's not like we're changing the status quo. It's just getting a little more dramatic. I don't know that that actually changes anything in terms of the dynamics of how college basketball plays out. A lot of that money is going to go to football still. That's not to say that basketball won't benefit from it, but a lot of that money is going to be spent on the program that made the money, which is obviously the football program. I think if the teams in the Big East, teams like Creighton, have found a way to be competitive with the dramatically smaller dollar amounts flowing in already, I don't necessarily see why that should change just because the dollar amounts have gotten a little bit higher. I mean, I know we're talking about a lot of money here, but again, the financial disparity between these universities and athletic departments was already enormous. At a certain point, how much more does it actually matter, right? What I think is going to matter a little bit more are the NIL deals, the collectives, the things like that. If some of the smaller schools aren't able to put those together, that could create a bigger gap, I think, than the TV money that you're getting from football.
And I brought this up last week, Ravi, and I'm curious what you think. The deal between the Big East and Fox goes until 2025. But ESPN is going to, because they're not, unless something changes, they're not going to have Big Ten basketball anymore. So there's going to be potentially some room there. Do you think there's a possibility maybe ESPN and the Big East get back into bed together again at some point?
I mean, yeah, ESPN's constantly trying to fill those programming hours, right?
Yep. And
the Big Ten basketball leaving leaves a pretty big hole in their winter. And that's just, I mean, that's just a fact, whether they necessarily care about that in terms of the, certainly not in the same way as they do college football, they still got to fill those hours. Would you rather fill it with the AAC? Or would you rather fill it with the Big East? I imagine you'd rather fill it with the Big East. Obviously, there's a historical partnership with a lot of the schools in the Big East and ESPN previously. I think it's a pretty easy match to make. I don't know if they would become the primary provider the way Fox is. But I know CBS takes on, specifically CBS Sports Network, takes on a lot of those kind of secondary games of the Big East. Maybe ESPN steps into that role and kind of becomes the second tier for those Big East basketball games. But it wouldn't surprise me at all. offensive line that is capable. I've got some concerns about that, obviously, with kind of all the moving pieces there and then the pieces that they lost, whether it's Nwili or Cam Jurgens. And, you know, I wonder about how healthy Prohaska is with coming off that injury. You know, there's a difference between getting cleared by a doctor and saying, hey, like, health-wise, you're 100% and being back to 100% football-wise. Those aren't always the same thing. So I wonder about the offensive line a lot, because if that's not right, then very little else is going to matter on that side of the ball. So to me, the offensive line from a football standpoint is the biggest question. Now, there's a lot of still big philosophical questions that, you know, about the makeup of the coaching staff and things like that, that, you know, we could get into as well. But from a football standpoint, just the makeup of the offensive line, and if they can patchwork that thing together to be a competent unit, that's my biggest question.
Ravi, you know, one of the things that I always like to do with myself personally as a season gets closer and as I'm trying to figure out, you know, where I'm right, where I'm wrong, is to just like poke holes in my own argument. Why will I be wrong? Why? You and I are kind of in the same boat. I think we're, you know, going to predict the same record.
The negative boys.
Why are you and I wrong? Why are we
negative
wrong?
The negative boys.
About Nebraska football in 2022. What happens on the field that you're like, I should have seen that coming?
You know, Mark Whipple's got a really long history of being a successful play caller and offensive coordinator. Mickey Joseph has a really long history of being really good at what he does. The running back room seems to be talented, even if a little bit murky at this point. If all the things that were meant to be changed, you know, the special teams improves and all the close games last year really were that close, and Nebraska really was that close to winning six or seven games last year instead of three. You know, it's not that hard to talk yourself into I can't talk myself into more than about seven or eight, like some people can, but it's not that hard to talk myself out of five. If the things that they changed go the way they are supposed to, right?
Mm-hmm.
That to me is the easiest thing to poke holes in, is like, hey, yeah, Scott Frost really has stepped away. He's taken more of a CEO role. It took him a while to adjust, but he's doing better now. And, you know, it's better for everybody involved. If that's true, they're probably a lot better than I think they are this year. That's the big question in terms of, you know, some of the philosophical stuff I was talking about. Real easy to poke that hole. If Scott Frost is the CEO that he needs to be, then I think a lot of my perception of what happens with this football season changes.
Ravi Lulla, you know, next week, it's going to be prediction week.
Oh, yeah.
Which means records.
Oh, yeah.
But I'm also working on something that I want to share with all of you, the people, and with all of our guests.
Oh.
Kind of a different way to predict things that will happen this season. So I look forward to hearing what some of your answers will be, and I'll share that with everyone over the weekend.
Okay.
And then we'll work on it next week.
And we're still doing predictions, right?
Yeah, absolutely. Okay, we're still doing that, but I'm just saying some declarative statements of things that you will think will happen.
Basically like the list. Put it on the list.
Kind of.
Get the eggs.
Kind of, yeah.
Okay, interesting.
So, Ravi, have a great time this weekend doing whatever it is you're going to be doing, because this is the last weekend without football games that count.
I'm in Chicago.
Oh, really? What are you doing in Chicago?
Awesome.
My best friend lives here. I just thought I'd go see him.
Oh, that's what a friend. What a great friend you are, Ravi.
You know, I try.
Well,
you succeed.
Enjoy whatever it is you're going to enjoy while you're in Chicago.
I will do my best. I'm sure it'll be a blast.
All right. Good. Ravi Lulla, ladies and gentlemen, who joins us every Thursday here on the program.
We haven't talked a whole lot about the Big Ten TV deal yet. I know we will. Matthew asks, will we need to subscribe to Peacock to watch Big Ten games after this new deal? We will indeed, friends.
If you want to watch all the Big Ten games, yes.
But
at least have access to all the Big Ten games, yes, you will have to subscribe to Peacock, because they will have roughly 8 regular season exclusive football games a year, and then I don't remember the exact number of the basketball.
Hoops is obviously more. I have it written somewhere.
I could look it up here. Let's see. Peacock. Each season, 8 regular season football games will appear on the platform, along with as many as 47 regular season men's basketball games and 30 regular season women's basketball games.
So if you want to watch Nebraska sports, football, men's or women's hoops, there will be at least one of the latter two, I would say, each on per year.
At least one.
And given that there are 8 football games, that's kind of a crapshoot. Maybe year one, maybe year two. At some point, they will. Yes, Nebraska football will absolutely air on Peacock at some point in time.
I'd be curious, and it doesn't say, but I'd be curious if there is like a requirement that every team must appear once.
Probably that's why I think it'd probably be over a 2-year span, unless all the Peacock games are just conference only, because that, of course, would allow you to do it pretty quickly.
Right.
So,
but again, would you want to quote unquote waste a Michigan game, even if it's against a Rutgers, on there versus a network might want to pick it up because, again, it's Michigan, the brands. But we'll see. We'll see how that works. But if you want to be assured that you will see every Nebraska game that's aired,
you'll probably need it.
You'll need Peacock.
Yeah. At some point in time, you'll need it. Maybe it's not 2023. Maybe it's 2024. But you're going to need it. There will be a football game on there for sure.
The good news is, through all of this, if you're one who is adverse to wanting to buy additional streaming packages, this is
pretty good.
This is it.
Pretty friendly.
Yeah.
This is friendly. It's like the NFL, right?
Yes.
The NFL, look, you need cable, you need Amazon, but man, a lot of NFL games are on over the air. If you just want to go off the rabbit ears, you can watch more games than not in a traditional weekend of football in the NFL. Look, the Big Ten just given the raw tonnage of it. That's not the case, but you can do it certainly in every time slot on the weekend. Every time slot, 11, 2:30, prime time, you're going to get a Big Ten game.
And what this may end up doing is maybe, now it won't be this way for a lot of the Olympic sports, but it may keep more basketball games from ending up on BTN Plus.
And that's like essentially the non-conference games for Nebraska.
Yes, and those are and BTN Yonka Plus Dunka. and BTN Plus is more expensive. Peacock, I think there's different tiers. I think you can get Peacock for like $10 a month.
You can get Peacock as low as $4.99 a month.
Yeah, that comes with a lot of commercials.
Oh, actually, you can get it for free. Now, I'm guessing the sports stuff will be behind the paywall.
Oh, yeah.
The cheapest premium one, which is limited ads, is $4.99, though. A football game, of course, is going to be normal ads. Or the ad-free one, which is for all the movies and the shows, is $10 a month. So for now, that's for now.
That's for now. They could change that pricing before it starts because they'll have more exclusive stuff. But
it'll go up.
Like right now, the Major League Baseball stuff, I think you can get it with the $4.99. So it's, you know.
Yeah, you can. Yeah, yeah. All the live sports, including right now, they have Premier League, they have WWE, they have Sunday Night Football.
They also have Sunday Morning Baseball.
The MLB Sunday thing. So, yeah. So you can get that right now for $5. So if you're a soccer fan, like if you're a Premier League fan and a Big Ten football fan, like this is pretty sweet for you because you'll have everything under one roof.
So it's possible that the BTN Plus might be limited more in its usage.
God, I hope so.
Because that's
I don't watch the non-conference Nebraska games.
No,
except for like when they play Creighton and a Big Ten ACC
but that's
challenge.
But that's always going to be
on TV.
It's always going to be on one of the networks.
Darn near every home game that Nebraska plays in the non-con, I don't watch because it's on BTN Plus. It's on BTN Plus. There's a couple of really good things, by the way, that I like, and I know you and I are going to be in lockstep on this. That I can't wait to talk about.
All right, we'll do that next. And then also, Robin Washut still coming up as the offensive coaches, including Donnie. Donnie spoke today.
I saw that.
But we will have whips later.
And chins?
No, chins was yesterday.
Oh. So you had the chins, you had the chains, and now the whips?
Yeah. Chins came first yesterday. Yeah. Now it's whips.
Hey, man, just get that leather and the zippers, and I'm feeling good.
We'll hear about the whips coming up and also anything else that was said today at Nebraska Offensive Media Day. Robin Washut will join us shortly here on Unsportsmanlike Conduct. And 1620 The Zone. For some of you, football season provides a natural high. You're ready to go. You are fired up. But unfortunately, for some men, erectile dysfunction is real. It's real and it sucks. It really does. Because not only does it affect your performance, you know where, but it also just can affect your mood and your overall quality of life. Well, if you don't want to be hooked on pills and having to time every intimate moment to the taking of a pill, call my friends at Brookside Medical, 402-671-7777, because right now you can get a blood flow ultrasound and a free consultation. That's right, free, over $500 value. The advanced wave technology that's used at Brookside has been shown to restore and regrow blood vessels. That improves blood flow and restores normal erectile function. Also, it's non-surgical, so you don't have to worry about knives or lasers or anything like that. And there's no lengthy recovery time, and you can go right back to normal life. So contact Brookside today and take advantage of this special offer today and get your not only performance back, but your good mood back with Brookside Medical, 402-671-7777.
Previously, you're on the crossover forecast from my Godfather's Pizza pool, Weather Center and KETV News Watch 7 on 1620 The Zone. Previously on the crossover. Previously on the crossover.
When you have the tin of popcorn, it has the four. The cheese, the white, the caramel.
Oh, you're bougie. You went
then,
four.
It's three. Is it three? Okay. Yeah. But there's always one that's about 75% gone before any of the others are touched. Which one is it?
Caramel?
Cheese. That's caramel.
Oh, no.
All three are garbage.
Whoa! Popcorn snob.
Sharp and Benning in the morning. The Connor Happer Show. Unsportsmanlike Conduct. 6A to 6P. 1620. The Zone. Your Omaha area forecast from the Godfather's Pizza Weather Center and KETV News Watch 7 on 1620 The Zone.
Mild and partly cloudy conditions will continue all throughout the early evening hours. As we head beyond 8 and 9 o'clock, there's a small chance of scattered showers and thunderstorms for the metro area. Scattered storms will continue throughout the overnight with a morning low of 64 degrees. For your Friday, looking at partly cloudy skies, on and off showers and storms will be possible with a high temperature of 84 degrees. I'm meteorologist Anthony Copeland for KETV News Watch 7.
1620 The Zone's Unsportsmanlike Conduct, brought to you by a great friend of the program, Union Bank and Trust.
This is Darcy with Dingman's Collision Center. We have run our business for years by helping the vehicle owner retain the value of their vehicle by working for them with warranted, safe, high-standard repairs. For this reason, Omaha vehicle owners have chosen Dingman's to repair their vehicles. Your loyalty has been shown through repeat business and amazing referrals. You've also voted us first place best of Omaha for the past 17 years. We want to say thank you for choosing the Dingman family and our incredible technicians to repair your vehicles. At Dingman's, we'd rather be the best than apologize for anything less.
Rock and country music's hardest hitters join forces. Yeah. Five Finger Death Punch. Brantley Gilbert. With special guest Corey Marks. November 30th, CHI Health Center, Omaha. On sale Friday, 10 a.m. at LiveNation.com. Five Finger Death Punch's new album, Afterlife, out Friday. Five Finger Death Punch and Brantley Gilbert, live.
Give your business a whole host of options with Host Coffee. The most impressive selection of office coffee, water options, healthy food options, and vending technologies. Host Coffee, serving you since 72.
Psst, come here. I got a secret weapon that'll make your family happy. Real happy.
It's my new caramel toffee cookie combo. My big chocolate chip cookie covered with caramel and toffee bits. Add any medium specialty pizza piled high with the best toppings and loads of mozzarella on top. Plus any medium one-topping pizza. Caramel toffee cookie combo.
Order now.
Godfather's Pizza. Do it.
Take your science or healthcare degree to the next level at College of St. Mary and apply to one of our in-demand graduate programs. Earn a Doctor of Physical Therapy with our online on-campus hybrid program. Earn a Master of Science in Physician Assistant Studies in just 2 years, or an Occupational Therapy Doctorate in 3 years. Graduate programs at CSM are inclusive and open to everyone. Plus, we offer an accelerated pathway to several of our healthcare programs for those needing their undergraduate degree. Apply today. Get started at csm.edu.
It's unsportsmanlike conduct. They have to play with themselves. The 1620. The Zone.
Tomorrow starts Big Red-ish week. It goes longer than an actual
The prologue.
Week.
That's a book term.
Yeah.
The prologue, John. And then the epilogue is Big Red Overreaction next Saturday. That's yeah, but after. It's at the end of the book.
I guess.
Yeah,
I suppose that works.
Thank you. Book boy.
Big Red Week Plus.
So that's what I want to call it that because that
like
fits
Big
in
Red
with the
ish
stream. It fits in
weekish.
With,
I like weekish.
Yeah, but plus
Big Red Weekish.
Plus makes it sound like it's a new streaming service.
Yeah, but we're not charging for it. We don't want people to think that we're charging for it. It starts tomorrow, brought to you by Union Bank and Trust, where your money has people, with the Sharp and Benning roundtable.
But then we can
the virtual roundtable.
We can add on to it. Like normally, if you see the plus, that means you got to pay for it. Here, still free content, baby. Still free.
Big Red Weekish. Which will feature us being at the Break the Curse event next Thursday.
Oh,
and we have other special events planned.
Oh,
so stand by as we count down and get ready. It's the final week before the start of the season.
Consider me standing by, John. Standing by.
Brought to you by Union Bank and Trust, where your money has people. So what does this mean? What does this contract mean money-wise?
Lots of it.
It is.
Nailed
it. Estimated to be anywhere between $7 and $8 billion altogether. By the end of the deal, each school is expected to receive $100 million a season. It wasn't that long ago when Nebraska's entire athletic department budget was $100 million.
Incredible.
I think I haven't seen the recent numbers, but I think it's like $130 or $140 million a year budget, I think.
Insane.
So, I mean, just this alone basically covers most of it. That's before you sell one ticket or anything else.
They better not charge more for the tickets, man.
I don't think ticket prices are going down in general. I think you can still get some deals right now, but I don't.
Oh,
think.
Actually, they are going down. Because they're like, hey, please, God, we want to fill the stadium up. We'll give it to you. We'll pay you to go.
They're not doing that.
They basically are.
It's still $30.
That's cheap. That's down from where it was. That's good. Keep going
so
down.
So that's what it's going to net each of these schools.
Yeah.
And we said as much when we found out last week that ESPN had pulled out of talks. If the Big Ten was going to do something, if they were going to go big, pardon the pun.
Nice.
If they were going to break away from ESPN, which, you know, which thought inconceivable. Oh, my God, you're leaving ESPN. You're leaving College Game Day. You're leaving Kirk Herbstreit.
Oh, good Lord. Settle down.
You were going to have to do something bold.
And this is bold.
It absolutely is.
As we said last segment, this is great. If you're a fan of football and you're honestly, you're a little sick of spending so much money on streaming services, like you still need them. But this is a hell of a compromise that you could wake up, plug in that digital antenna. Depending on where you live in Omaha, maybe you don't get Fox 42, but you'll definitely get CBS and you'll definitely get NBC. And you can watch the 11 a.m. game, the 2:30 game, and the primetime game without the need of cable. You can watch those three time slots all day long if you want to.
Yeah, every single week.
Every
week. Now, the CBS deal is going to be a little wonky at the beginning because they're going to have a little crossover. Their deal with the SEC goes through next season.
Yeah, so they're only going to air 7 Big Ten games next year, whereas normally, starting in 24, they will broadcast up to 15 games, including an afternoon game on Black Friday.
But not just that. It'll be a primetime Black Friday game, too.
On NBC. So that's what, you know, I said last segment, there's something that I think we'll both like. I love this. Like, that was, of all the things that were cool, and there's really a lot of stuff that I like in here, Black Friday, the Big Ten having 2 Black Friday games on over-the-air television, I think is very cool. I mean, really, the traditionalists will probably eat it up. CBS broadcasting a Nebraska game again on Black Friday, if they're the afternoon game, NBC doing the night. It's just, you know, that's where it all kind of started. They were on CBS a lot at Thanksgiving time of year. So that's pretty cool. I'm very interested to see who the other game will involve, if it will be kind of a locked-in opponent or game or matchup, or if it will rotate, because I know there was reporting within the last few weeks that they've kicked that idea around the league and other schools are not interested in it.
Right.
So that'll probably be kicking and screaming into Black Friday.
But you wonder if the fact that, hey, we're going to guarantee you a network exposure. This isn't going to be, you know, put on FS1. or Peacock, this will be on NBC or this will be on CBS if it might encourage some other folks. And I think it's a good thing, A, that Nebraska and Iowa have both agreed to continue to do this, because now if other people start to see the benefit of being on Black Friday, they'll look at it and say, oh, I want in. It might be one of those things where you hated it at first, but then all of a sudden you see how cool it is.
Didn't Iowa kind of do that? Iowa didn't want it at first.
Iowa wasn't originally that enthralled with it because they had never done it. But once they got exposure to it, it was like, hey, this is a pretty cool deal. And now they are as invested in playing on Black Friday as Nebraska.
John, remember when Sean Eichhorst canceled Black Friday for like 5 seconds? Iowa was going to play Wisconsin, I believe, or yes. Minnesota. They were going to play on Black Friday. They wanted to stay on Black Friday. So you're right. I think, like, yes, it makes your week a little harder, a little more difficult, but talk about exposure. You're all by yourself and a night game. And I said something along these lines earlier today, but think about how far this league has come in such a short amount of time. Not that long ago, they didn't want primetime games in the month of November because of weather. And now they will have a night game on Black Friday, the latest regular season weekend of the entire year. And we haven't mentioned this one just yet either, but there will be a Labor Day game on Sunday that NBC will air this season or starting in 2023 as well. So the Big Ten, which was very traditional, and in November, you could only have two time slots, 11 or 2:30 or noon and 3:30 if you're on the East Coast. Now, obviously noon tonight, but a Labor Day Sunday, which I've been pushing for a Nebraska Labor Day game for years or a Thursday game for years. I think that that's a really cool, fun way to kick off the season. This is good. Get the Big Ten on Sunday. Like, I think that that's a really good thing because that weekend is very valuable real estate and you get some of the most watched, you know, games of the entire season usually come on that Sunday.
And you're going to get, and this again to the folks who are like, well, this means game day will never come back. And it might not, you know, ESPN might, you know,
I'll take you on that bet.
They may or they may not.
I know. I'm just saying, I'll take you on that bet. They'll be at a Big Ten school again. They can't ignore the league.
I'm not saying they're going to ignore the league, but even if they did, I would much rather be on three over the air network television stations every single week in separate time slots from morning to night than be on College game day.
Yeah.
The impact of College game day, it's a great visual. It is national exposure. But remember, that show only pulls in between 1 and 2 million viewers per week. These games are going to double, triple, quadruple, depending on if it's Ohio State, Michigan, quintuple that. And you're going to be on there every week. The ratings on over-the-air network television are generally higher anyway than a comparable game on a cable channel because there's just more televisions that have access to those networks. And there's still something about being on network TV, which is why the NFL has always insisted, hey, our playoff games, our Super Bowl, always on network TV.
And along those lines, how about this from Richard Deitch today on The Athletic? Multiple sources said Amazon was willing to pay more than what CBS and NBC ultimately paid for a spot in either primetime or the 3:30 p.m. Eastern time slot. So think about that. Amazon was willing to spend more money. That goes along with what you just said. It's obviously important to the league that they have over-the-air games.
Yes,
it's obviously
easy exposure. They have easy access to the majority of their games.
Deitch is incredibly plugged in. That means will be a little poorer, which they're going to be.
They're not going to be poor,
but they turned down more money because they would rather be on over-the-air. That's pretty interesting.
Not only do you get those games, but you get the promotion.
Relegation?
No.
Oh.
No,
not that kind of promotion.
You're gonna get promotion. Jim Nance on the NFL is gonna talk about next week's Big Ten game. Mike Tirico is gonna be talking about that Saturday night's game on Sunday Night Football. Not to mention whatever promotional run they get on regular primetime television. And you're gonna have the power of, you know, all of those local affiliates. who are going to be invested in having, hey, we're going to have Big Ten football. That's huge for all of these schools. And it's huge for the league. So to make a move, can a league afford to walk away from ESPN? The answer is emphatically yes.
Couple other things stood out to me. The Big Ten Championship game will not be on Fox exclusively anymore. They will broadcast it in 23, 25, 27, and 29. CBS will have it in 24 and 28. And NBC, of course, is a seven-year deal, so that's why there's going to be an odd number of these that I'm mentioning. NBC will get it in 2026. Also, there was a quote from Sean McManus, right, with CBS, because I've been wondering, are like all the best games going to be on Fox? No, they're still doing a draft. So, you know, for those of you who are like me, and you don't always want the best game at 11, have no fear, because there will be some weeks where CBS has the best game. There will be some weeks where NBC has the best game, but they'll just rotate. That said, obviously Michigan and Ohio State will forever be on Fox as long as this.
Yeah, because Fox is always going to have first pick.
Yeah, so
and they're always going to take that game first because it's an annual $10 million a year.
Yeah.
10 million viewers a year at least.
But that'll rotate. Also, we haven't had, you know, and I know we're up against it, we haven't had time to talk about it yet, but there's still little hints being dropped, including the one by Brett McMurphy, where he said that according to a source, Big Ten expansion is not done. I believe Dennis Dodd, I think he said something. So a lot of people are saying something similar. McMurphy's going to join us tomorrow at 2:50. So we'll talk about that and perhaps more with him. But I'm with you. I think this is great for the league. I think this is great for fans. I understand the frustration with Peacock, but as a few other people pointed out, you used to shell out $50, $60. I did this for pay-per-view.
Pay-per-view.
And now you do $10 a month, multiply it by three, multiply it, including all the basketball games. You're still talking $70 or $80. And that's, it'll probably go up in price. It's better than two pay-per-view games for over $100. You know, because you get a lot more games.
Plus, you get all the stuff that's on Peacock.
The Office, Parks and Rec, I believe, is on there. Other stuff.
You can watch all the WrestleManias.
Premier League. All sorts of things.
Well, we want to entice them to get the Peacock. We don't want to scare them away. If Husker fan finds out that they have to share airspace with soccer.
Oh, that'll be great.
Coming up next, Robin Washut of Husker. Well, it's almost. It's still Nebraska coming soon.
2 weeks from today, it's September 1st.
On 1620 The Zone.
You could win $5,000 to have the ultimate tailgate party on 1620 The Zone. Enter now at 1620thezone.com.
It is Big Red Friday, August 26th at McDonald's. You'll score a limited edition Husker flag for just $5. You're looking for a good cause? The proceeds benefiting your local Ronald McDonald House. That's a good deal. Those families, they go through enough. We want to take the burden off of those families by supporting the Ronald McDonald House. Should a Husker fan like you need a flag? Absolutely. Stop on out. It's Big Red Friday, August 26th at your local McDonald's.
Finding great candidates to hire can be like, well, trying to find a needle in a haystack. Sure, you can post your job to some job board, but then all you can do is hope the right person comes along, which is why you should try ZipRecruiter for free at ziprecruiter.com/radio. ZipRecruiter doesn't depend on candidates finding you. It finds them for you. Its powerful technology identifies people with the right experience and actively invites them to apply to your job. You get qualified candidates fast. So while other companies might deliver a lot of hay, ZipRecruiter finds you what you're looking for. The needle in the haystack.
See why 4 out of 5 employers who post a job in ZipRecruiter get a quality candidate within the first day. ZipRecruiter, the smartest way to hire. And right now you can try ZipRecruiter for free. That's right. Free at ZipRecruiter.com/radio. That's ZipRecruiter.com/radio. ZipRecruiter.com/radio.
Tide presents Laundry Truths, Cold Hard Savings.
Oh, hey, about to start a load. On hot? You know, washing in cold water with Tide can save you up to $150 a year on your energy bill.
$150? Go on.
The lower the temp, the lower your bills. Simple. Plus, Tide Pods are designed for a powerful clean, even in cold.
Wow, cool tip. Get it?
Oh yeah, I get it.
Turn to cold and save with Tide. Energy savings based on average from switching from hot to cold in non-AC machines.
Kirsten Bernthal Booth with Creighton Volleyball here. The 2022 season has arrived, and we need you in the stands as we look to defend our Big East title. Our 15-match home schedule is one of our best ever. In addition to our tough Big East slate, we are also hosting some of the top teams in the country, including Kentucky, USC, and Nebraska. Don't miss any of the action this season and get your tickets online now at gocreighton.com/buy. Go Jays!
After 24 years, Horseman's Park will close for major renovations on Sunday, September 18th. The original simulcast facility will be changed forever, so don't miss this final opportunity to watch and wager on over 700 TVs with weekly food and drink specials, door prizes, and so much more. Time is running out to be a part of Nebraska's horse racing history. Now through September 18th, open 7 days a week. Horseman's Park, Omaha's best bet.
Your neighborhood is more than blocks of buildings. It's the people who live there that make it special. At Union Bank and Trust, we're not just creating home loans, we're making neighbors. We're not just small business lenders, we're small business shoppers. We don't just live in your community, we help you build it. Because our people are your people. Visit uet.com/neighbor to learn more. Union Bank and Trust, member FDIC.
1620 The Zone's Unsportsmanlike Conduct is brought to you by Union Bank and Trust. Now back to the program. Robin Washut.
Blissful ignorance, I think it could be an advantage here.
Robin Washut.
Yeah, I'm a ball guy. Yeah.
Yeah, it's going to be absolutely huge.
The hot take.
Wash it. Wash it's good. Wash it.
Yeah, wash it's real good.
Wash it. Wash it's good. Wash it.
Yeah, wash it's real good.
Well, somebody else who's not going to get one damn dime out of this Big Ten television money, along with us, is Robin Washut of On3.com. Nebraska coming soon.
Oh, and it's coming soon, all right.
It is coming soon.
2 weeks, maybe.
Hello. Very good. Yeah. Hello, Robin.
Hello.
Oh, I forgot to tell you this, John. I saw Robin on Saturday.
Oh, please tell me you had your shirt on.
We were both rocking tank tops. Bro tanks.
Yeah, we were bro taking pretty hard.
Oh yeah.
Where?
We were at a music. What do you call it, Robin? A festival? A music festival?
Full blown 2 day music festival.
Were you at both days?
I was at both days.
Nice. Me too, man. I had a great time.
What kind of music?
You know, like it was rock? Like the full like dad rock essentials for guys my age. I'm sure some of those bands were a little before Josh's time, but. I loved every bit of it. It was down at Falconwood Park out by Bellevue. Mm-hmm. And it was 2 days of just really good shows that I was very much into. I took the whole family and everybody had a blast.
Yeah, what I liked, Robin, because I haven't been to a music festival in years. I didn't realize now they have them where you can like bring your own little folding chair. So we were just sitting the whole time. I didn't even have to stand. It was great.
Oh, it was beautiful. You stake out a spot, you get your little blanket down, your chairs.
Yep.
Basically have your own little like campsite for the whole festival. And you know, you can have the options going up front if you're into that sort of thing. But yep. I have little kids with me. So I hung back and just enjoyed the comfort of my lounge chairs.
Now Robin, Josh is famously known for eschewing music and listening to copious podcasts.
Oh yeah.
He
double
never
speed.
Listens to music. So is he just like aimlessly wandering around going, "Where's Stuart Mandel?"
Okay, why is it always Mandel?
Where's Feldman?
He kept trying to tell everybody why, you know, he thought this was such a critical year for Scott Frost. For some reason, no one there really wanted to hear about it. So I guess he's just talking to nobody.
Before we get into some of the football stuff, because the offensive coaches spoke today, Ernie Ziegler was officially announced yesterday as Nebraska's newest assistant. Here is a fill-in-the-blank question for you, Robin. Ernie Ziegler will do blank for Nebraska that hasn't been done or done as well as before.
That's a good question.
Nice.
He will do it all. And by what I mean by do it all is he will be a high level on-court instructor, coach. He will be critical in their game planning and opponent scouting. And he will be a primary recruiter both nationally and internationally. So, you know, when Fred, you know, made the comment that Ernie checked every box, that's what he needs. If you've got a different level of experience than, you know, a lot of guys on staff and guys that have been on staff, and his recruiting track record certainly is prominent, speaks for itself. And then also just his experience that he's had as a head coach and as a high major assistant coach kind of gives him a resume that's really hard to replicate, especially considering the pool of candidates Fred Hoiberg had to work with. To be able to find a guy of that caliber was about as good as it could get, for my opinion, for whatever it's worth. But, you know, I think that is what he's going to do is he's going to do everything. And with the way Nebraska's staff has been constructed, especially the last, you know, 3 years, that hasn't, you haven't been able to say that, where everybody had really specific roles, whether it was this is the on-court coach, this is your defensive coach, this is your recruiter. Now, in this kind of full staff effort where everybody's doing a little bit of something, Ernie Ziegler really embodies everything about that, both as a coach and as a recruiter.
So is this arrangement contrary to what the arrangement was before, where you had Abdul Massey, who was the recruiting guy, and then everyone else had their different bench roles? This is part of, obviously, the change that Hoiberg wanted to make, you know, after last season and getting the extra, you know, time from Trev Alberts. Is this an arrangement you think that Hoiberg ultimately will be comfortable with?
Yeah, it's probably one that needed to happen. Obviously, he tried to kind of replicate what he did at Iowa State. And I was have Matt Ablamasi do the lion's share, or if not all, of the recruiting for the program, and be able to just kind of use that Rolodex to fill out the roster. Well, you know, got him high-level recruits, but for whatever reason, it didn't work here. So now they're going with a more traditional approach where all the coaches go out and recruit, and everybody can go have a say in the types of players they recruit and the ones that they pursue, and kind of just make it more of a complete you know, staff say in recruiting, whereas before it was predominantly one guy and the head coach. So, you know, Adam Howard certainly fits that mold as well. He's a high-level recruiter. And what's interesting to me is you kind of see the dynamic with these three full-time assistants now. You know, you have Nate Lenzer, who has kind of established himself as their in-state guy or their regional guy, who's going to, you know, really be on the in-state recruit. You know, guys from Western Iowa, South Dakota, you know, Kansas, and those sort of things. Where Adam Howard is going to be, you know, he's got his territories as well, but, you know, he's going to be really heavy in the transfer portal with his connections, you know, with transfers. And then now with Ernie Ziegler, like I said, he's a national level recruiter. He's recruited on both coasts. He's got ties to Texas, the Southeast, obviously in the upper Midwest, being a native of Detroit. And then, like I said, he's got international ties as well. He's still currently running the NBA Academy Africa program. And one of his former players at UCLA that he recruited is the head coach out there. So, you know, there's a lot of different angles where Ernie's going to be able to hit differently than the other two assistants. But each one is going to kind of have their primary recruiting focuses. I think that's the right approach. In today's age of recruiting, you need to have you know, guys versed in every phase, where not only do you recruit locally, not only do you recruit nationally, not only do you recruit the portal, you do it all. And so I think with this combination of assistant coaches, they're able to do that, where they've now addressed all the areas that they really need to prioritize on the recruiting trail and have guys that are skilled in, like I said, they're very specific in different areas.
Robin, turning to football, you know, there's been a lot of talk this week about the offensive line and I guess maybe how much Frost is or isn't involved with Donovan Raiola. If the line struggles this year or succeeds with the first-year position coach, in your opinion, is that going to be more on Raiola for getting it done? Or how much like credit, I guess, are you going to give Frost for succeeding or failing with the line, given that he kind of took a flyer on someone who was so inexperienced?
Yeah, it's hard for me to put all of the blame on a position coach that, you know, in a lot of respects, didn't recruit anybody that he's working with. So, I kind of give him a bit of a leeway on that. But certainly, if there's a dramatic improvement, you got to give credit where credit's due, where clearly Donovan Raiola will have had an influence on that group that turned them from an extreme liability to maybe even an asset. And so that, I guess it kind of remains to be seen just kind of how you gauge that. But, you know, I guess the good thing for Donovan is the bar is pretty low with that offensive line, where they would have to be pretty bad for them to say that they were worse than they were last year. But, you know, I think that also allows the opportunity for the market improvement, where you certainly have to give him credit for that. But then you also have to give credit to Frost for, finding a guy that was able to flip whatever switches needed to be hit to make those changes. So it's a collective deal, I think, where you can give credit and blame for certain situations equally between Raiola and Frost. But I think that you're probably going to be looking at where they've improved as opposed to where they've gotten worse just because the unit was so rough last year.
We're going to hear a little bit from Whips later in the program. That's what they call them.
I know they do.
But what was your biggest takeaway from today's offensive media session?
He touched on a lot of different things. He declined to name the starting quarterback, even though everybody knows who it could be. He said some of the positives had been overall the ball security has been really good, and the fundamental consistency in the running game had also been a really big positive that goes equally to the running back and to the offensive line. I think that they've liked the progress they've seen in that particular area. And I thought it was interesting too, a week ago, the last time we talked to Whipple, he was pretty hard on that offense and they had a really rough day and really struggled in a lot of different ways. And he said that was by far their worst day of the entire fall camp, and that overall he's been very pleased with the performance and progression of the offense. And actually, when he went back and watched the film after that practice last week, he said it wasn't as bad on film as it was at first glance watching it live. So, a lot of positive reviews about the progress made thus far. But I think obviously everybody knows there's still unknowns that remain until they take the field against the live opponent, and guys continue to fit into a new offense and in some cases into new roles.
Robin, what do you think of the point spread for the opener next week?
Yeah, well, it's thought that was like 13 now, on Circus Sports. That's a big number. Obviously, last year showed that number is certainly possible, but I think that those types of margins have by far been the outlier, and this series has always been really close down to the wire. And so to think this is going to be a 2-score game, history certainly suggests it's not. I've learned the hard way not to doubt Vegas far too many times when it comes to these sorts of things. So take my opinion for what it's worth, but when it comes to Nebraska Northwestern, I'm always going to assume it's going to be a close game, probably a relatively ugly game that comes down to the last one or two possessions that ultimately decides it. So in theory, that would eliminate a 2-touchdown deficit one way or the other. But again, the guys in Vegas are a lot smarter than I am.
By the way, if you want to bet Nebraska, you can get an extra half point if you bet on the FanDuel Sportsbook.
Promo code
1620.
Indeed.
Yeah. That half ahead. Point could be a big deal.
It could be.
Oh, it could be, baby.
Yeah. I don't know many games that end with a 12.5 point margin.
Nope.
Don't think it ever happens.
I'm pretty sure it hasn't. Now, we are going to effort, because Robin, along with many of our regulars,
are
heading east. Unless it gets rerouted like on three's last exposition in the air,
yeah.
And you end up getting routed through Beijing. but we're going to effort to have Robin live from Ireland next week.
Do the accent. I know you want to do the accent.
I do, but I'm not going to. I saved that for the first segment.
Okay.
But yeah. Safe
we're gonna
journey.
Try to have him on
safe journey. Please make sure that Sipple keeps his shoes on the plane.
Ooh,
because
on an international flight, if you go shoeless, like you're really putting yourself out there for criticism. And I will be the first one to call him out on it.
Yeah,
good.
That's inexcusable. Shoes off on the plane thing. You can't do that.
Is Sip insisting on one of those flights where you get like the sleeping bunk?
No, Simple has actually a very low maintenance traveler. I mean, obviously he likes to take his shoes off, but he does not require a lot of amenities. So I think he's going to be just fine. It's a matter of, like I said, just what how much clothing he actually keeps on with his clothes, and he's a guy that. Likes to make sure that he's nice and cozy in wherever seat he's in. So I feel for whoever has to sit next to him. I looked at the seat map. I am not sitting next to him. So at least I got that goal.
Nice.
Which is nice. Uh-huh. All right. Robin Washut on 3.com. Nebraska coming soon. New name coming soon.
Robin, the next time we talk to you when you're in America, there will be a new name attached to it.
There will be a new name, and it will not be Nebraska coming soon.
I'm going to miss it.
It will be here.
Nebraska's here. That's the name. That's the new name.
Nebraska's here. That is actually the new name.
Honestly,
spoiler alert.
You guys should be, you know, if you start dropping podcasts, you know, you
I think they will be on.
You need to rename the podcast Nebraska Coming
Soon. The Nebraska Coming Soon podcast.
Yeah. Got to keep the name in the family.
Yeah, indeed.
Or else we'll take
it. I'll throw that up the chain of command.
All right.
Awesome.
Robin, have a great weekend. Thanks.
Safe travels, Robin.
Yeah, see you guys.
Robin Washut, HuskerOnline.com.
That's going to be so nice. I'm happy for all those guys. September 1st, going to be a good day for them and the family.
Yes.
It's going to be a very good day.
Yes, it will.
Also, it's going to be nice for us because we've accidentally
together again. They'll all be together again.
I wonder if that there's the one guy. He hasn't been writing. I wonder how his typing fingers are going to do. He's going to be writing again.
He's going to be very rusty.
Yeah, and they're going to be doing a pod. Did you see this tweet, by the way, from Amazing Daniel? Because he was among the people I saw at this festival. I saw Asian Joe. But I saw Amazing Daniel. He says, I spotted Josh walking by and later took a detour to say hello. I was going to make a joke about expecting to find him reading a book, and then I found him reading a book.
You are pathetic.
John, there was no music for like a half hour. It was a warm, sunny day. I wanted to finish my Lakers book. I was finishing my Lakers book. It was great.
What kind of a music festival doesn't have music going on all the time?
This wasn't one of the, this wasn't like the Warped Tour. This was like
the
you
Warped
see
Tour. Like, yeah, that's over my head.
Yeah, I was gonna, yeah you probably don't get tour. That. You know
what's
what the
that?
Warped Tour is. Yeah. It's a Warped Tour. That's like for like teenagers and stuff. But anyway, they'd have a band and then that they had one stage. The band would leave. They'd re-angle the stage over the next half hour. And I sat there reading a book. It was lovely. It was a lovely afternoon.
Okay.
Finished my Lakers book.
I teased a little bit earlier. We were talking about Big Reddish Week or Big Red Weekish.
Red Out Week. It starts tomorrow.
We're gonna have we have confirmed some details on another thing that we're gonna invite you to. Man,
what?
we're gonna be so out and about. It's gonna make our heads spin.
Yeah, because next week, of course, we're gonna be in Lincoln. We're going to be in Lincoln for the Break the Curse event. But if you're saying, oh, man, I can't make it to Lincoln. Well, we're going to be in Omaha, not just here at the station.
So that's coming up here on 1620 The Zone. John Bishop here for my friends at McCarthy's 1 Hour Heating and Air Conditioning. These gentlemen and ladies have been in the customer service business for over 50 years, professionally trained, certified and drug tested technicians who really take every person's task seriously. If you have an AC on the fritz or a furnace that's not working, McCarthy's has been there helping you every step of the way, and they always get the job done right the first time, every time. And for over 50 years, their promise has been always on time or you don't pay a dime. They really do take customer service very seriously. And if you join the Comfort Club right now at McCarthy's1hour.com, you no longer will have to worry about whether or not your AC is going to work the first time you turn it on or your furnace is operating safely, because you get a twice annual inspection. So you'll know what to expect. They'll come out before the peak heating and cooling seasons and make sure everything is working just right. And if there are repairs that need to be made, you can get discounts on repairs, other benefits, and you always move to the front of the line Comfort Club members when there is problems and it's a busy season. So go to McCarthy's1hour.com and take advantage of the McCarthy's customer service difference. McCarthy's1hour.com. McCarthy's 1 hour heating and air conditioning. Always on time or you don't pay a dime.
1620, The Zone Traffic.
From the Burton AC Heating, Plumbing, and More time-saving traffic center. Currently no wrecks to avoid. We are getting the reports of delays for both directions on Highway 275 between Center and 165th, causing a 3 to 5 minute delay through there. Looking at about a 2 to 3 minute delay if you're south on the JFK between I-80 and F Street. Same goes with heavy traffic on the northbound JFK between Childs and Chandler. And the left lane is closed on the northbound JFK between L Street and F Street, causing delays as well. I'm Mike Neville.
This time-saving traffic is brought to you by Fernando's Omaha.
Thanks, Omaha. Thanks for voting Fernando's number one for Omaha's Choice Awards for Best Mexican Restaurant and Best Margarita. Grab a friend or the whole family and get your fix. Two locations and open 7 days a week. Fernando's, family-owned and community-served.
Hi guys, it's Andrew with Brookside Medical Clinic. Is erectile dysfunction damaging your relationship? Are you sick of the pill and all the side effects? Well, welcome to the future. We have a major medical breakthrough. Brookside Medical Clinic uses the most advanced form of wave therapy. Backed by 60 clinical studies, our technology uses pressure waves to repair and open up blood vessels. We've helped countless men get rid of their ED. But what is the true end result? Their relationship, even their lives, improve drastically. If you're ready to regain your love life, call us right now, and not only will the assessment and ultrasound be free, we'll also give you a gift that produces immediate results in the bedroom. It almost never fails. This is worth $550, and it's free to callers right now. 402-671-7777. That's 402-671-7777. Put a stop to your erectile dysfunction and experience what I call the happiness ripple effect. Call Brookside Medical Clinic now. 402-671-7777.
Email Sharp and Betting on the Equitable Bank inbox with whatever is on your mind. The Zone inbox is brought to you by Equitable Bank. We take banking personally. You can get me at Gary at 1620thezone.com. We want to hear from you on the Equitable Bank Zone inbox.
Since this is a radio commercial, you can't see the people standing behind me. They're the Langfeld family. Everybody wave. Oh, sorry. You can't see them because... radio. Anyway, the Langfelds are the family behind Langfeld Overhead Door, where they proudly install Midland garage doors to fit any space and style, and they don't take a backseat to anyone when it comes to their service. Because if something goes wrong, it's their name on the line. So they're going to make sure it goes right every single time. Langfeld Overhead Door, 402-234-2700.
Oh, are you seeing these readings? This is incredible.
Short-staffed, Marco's climate research facility is in the eye of the storm. The atmospheric pressure to find more weather specialists is mounting.
Man, this is going to be a big job. We're going to need a bigger team.
Indeed can help him hire great people fast.
I need Indeed.
Indeed you do. We instantly connect you with quality candidates whose resumes on Indeed match your job description. Visit Indeed.com/credit and get $75 towards your first sponsored job. Terms and conditions apply.
Shop Woodhouse Place Hyundai and Nissan, 144th and Giles. KOZN Bellevue, Omaha, Council Bluffs.
Big Red Week around the world-ish. Brought to you by Union Bank and Trust. Starts
Red
tomorrow.
Out Week. It's Red Out Week, John.
Red Out Week-ish starts tomorrow with the Sharp and Benning Virtual Roundtable. Because all their guests will be, they'll be on the phone and on the stream yard.
I hope
stuff.
That they make their guests sit at round tables.
Well, it depends on, you know, what they have in their homes. But it's always a good time because they cover a lot of different subjects, get a lot of different opinions That'll be tomorrow. And then next week, of course, all of our shows. Thursday, this program will be in Lincoln.
Oh, baby.
At Haymarket Park the Break the Curse event.
Oh, baby.
We're attempting, along with our sister station, KLIN in Lincoln, to break the curse that has been, that has befallen this program. We're watching right now on Big Ten Network, another Big Ten classic. You suppose they put the Nebraska-Notre Dame game on there because the Irish are going to be joining the Big Ten soon?
Bingo!
Well, they're not going to be joining the Big Ten soon, but, at that time, it didn't feel like a curse was on the program.
Uh-huh.
That was 21 years ago. That game was 21 years ago.
Cool. That makes me feel... You were younger than I am right now. You were 30.
That was...
John, you were young and spry.
That was 3 days before 9/11, that game.
I traveled that Saturday. I was in an airport.
Yeah. But
we'll be there.
We're going to try to break the curse. So we're encouraging you to come up with some ideas of, you know, things we need
things to light on fire.
Yeah, we're gonna try to you know, sacrifice some things to the gods.
Maybe we could bring the little dolls and poke them.
We could bring
John will have a Steve Peterson doll.
We could, yeah. We could have a voodoo doll.
Yeah,
the Killigans will be there
and
performing.
Black. What if I screamed that every time?
Oh, we're going
the
to scream
Scarlet
that.
And the Cream
and Black. In fact, we're going to encourage everyone to do that.
They'll be like, "What the hell?"
And there'll be concessions, including adult beverages.
I love adult beverages.
And the event is free.
Free? F-R-E-E,
free? Now, the concessions are not free. I mean, it is concession.
But actually, John's paying for them all for it.
I didn't say that.
He'll be like, take my credit card, friend.
And it'll say Josh F. Peterson on the credit
card. Not my middle initial.
But that's next Thursday. So the program will be live, and then all the curse-breaking stuff, that'll happen, you know, after the program at 6
mm-hmm.
with the Killigans. So make sure you're there.
Before you get to the next announcement, did you see this tweet from Coach Ty earlier?
No, I didn't.
So Coach Ty pushed up the glasses on the bridge of his nose because he's not called my friends at Kugler Vision yet.
Oh, because he's correcting me on Big Route Week around the world-ish?
No, though we did get an email from Zach that says, Nebraska's playing in Ireland in a week. So, red out around the world? No, it's red out week, friends. Red out week. But
around the world.
Coach Ty says, I cannot get behind this nonsense. Husker football isn't cursed. They're just bad. I hope this season changes that or begins to, but I won't hold my breath. He is out on our event. Sad.
Well, think of it as a fun before the season pep rally. Then treat it like a pep rally. There'll be more beer legal at this event than at a Nebraska football home game.
And there's
think about that.
Wow, that's sad.
Think about that. Well, it's sad for people that go to the games, but
not
it's
sad
good
for
us.
Yeah, one beer Thursday.
So that's next Thursday, a week from today at Haymarket Park in Lincoln. Then next Friday.
The Dame Benning Breakdown's
we
back.
Have
is
not,
that what it is?
We haven't done this in a while.
It's been a few years.
But the Red Out Week Around the World-ish lunch will be at Oscar's Pizza and Sports Grill in West O, 172nd and Center.
Oh.
And we're all going to be there.
All of us?
It's not just Connor, because that's his time.
He is. Yeah, he's doing the full show there from 10 to 2.
We're going to be there.
You like you and me?
And the boys in the morning are going to be
there. Gary and Damon? Gary?
We have never been all together since this. We haven't been all together since...
All
like 8 or 9 years
now.
Ago.
All together now.
Where like all the shows came together as one.
It's been a long time.
Yeah, over the noon hour, all of us will be at Oscars at 172nd and Center.
Wow.
Together. And on the air, of course.
That's awesome.
So if you're thinking about lunch plans for next Friday.
Come hang out with us.
Come hang out with us at Oscars at 172nd and Center. And you can see us all live.
Awesome.
And you can.
I'm getting wings. I'm getting wingies. I'm going to order that from the server. Could I have some wingies, please? All flats. How do you feel about the all flats? I actually have never ordered
you're
all flats.
Fine. You take all the flats. I'll take all the drummies.
Oh, that's perfect. I'll be like, he wants the drums. I want the flats.
Yeah, absolutely.
Let's go. They'll be like, okay.
I'm down with that.
Awesome.
I'm totally down with that. So that is next Friday. And of course, all of our Red Out Week is brought to you by Union Bank and Trust, where your money has people.
Also, John has volunteered.
I haven't done this.
To take over Big Red Overreaction all by himself.
No.
The following day.
No.
What a guy. What a guy.
No, I don't want to deny you and Gary your God-given right.
By the way, in all seriousness, yeah, Gary and I, we got you covered for Overreaction. But we will be streaming that on 1620 The Zone TV all season long. Because some games last year were on the stream. This year, all the post-game shows will be on 1620 The Zone TV. So that's fun. How awesome is that?
And 1620thezone.com.
Yeah. 1620thezone app.
You know, the usual
YouTube,
places.
Twitch, yada, yada, yada. Zach says an exorcism needs to be part of breaking the curse.
Again, all ideas are welcome. We may not be able to get to all of them.
I've never seen them.
We may
movie.
Not legally be able to do them. I mean, Josh's murder cult has some interesting ideas that
I don't know.
None of them will be able to do.
I don't know what you're talking about.
But yes, send us your ideas.
I got to
for next Thursday.
Tape the piece of wood to my item.
Send us your ideas next Thursday, and we'll try to do as many as we can. And please join us if you can in Lincoln at Haymarket Park.
Yes, that's gonna be awesome.
I think which ice is performing, or is it 50 Cent? Someone's concerting over at the Pinnacle Bank Arena that night.
I believe it's 50.
Is it 50?
50 Cents.
It was either 50 or one of the ices. I can't remember.
Vanilla or?
Well, there's Ice Cube.
Ice Cube.
And
Who's the ice?
Ice-T.
Ice-T. Yeah.
Yeah. I couldn't remember.
One of the ices.
Well, I couldn't remember. That's not ISIS as in the terrorist group. Is it one of the ices as in plural of ice?
That, wow. If Jack Mitchell was a part of that, and we got ISIS here. Jack, no. Jack, what are you doing? What are you doing?
You know, the talking season, thank God, is almost over.
Oh, I'm going to miss it.
But, you know, Phil Steele, he does the rankings.
We're finally getting to this. I've had it on my sheet for a week and a half.
He does the rankings of...
he ranks everything.
He does.
That dude loves him some rankings.
He loves him some rankings. Yeah. And he doesn't do all 130 teams, though at some point I think he's going to. What does he do, like a top 70 or
I was going to ask you, because as we're going to say, one of the position groups for Nebraska ranks lower than 65. Because I figure, oh, you just do the Power 5. Nope, that one of their groups ranks 67. So I don't know how many he ranks.
Maybe he does rank them all. I don't
Maybe
know.
Maybe he does.
Well, he doesn't, because they were unranked at two positions. One of which, by the way, I think, and I didn't have time to ask this of Robin, but if there is a position group that has improved the most, particularly after spring football, or at least I think has the potential to be the most improved, especially after spring football, it was one of the groups that was unranked, but we'll get to that in a second.
Okay.
So Phil Steele had Nebraska's quarterbacks 52nd, running backs 44th, receivers 34th, offensive line 67th.
Ooh.
Linebacker 13th. Now I'm wondering, I bet he's counting O'Shawn as a linebacker.
Yes.
And probably Caleb Tanner is a linebacker.
Yeah, I would
too.
Agree. I would agree.
Even though they have been reclassified as edge.
Yeah.
And defensive back 56th.
That's interesting.
The unranked position groups, defensive line, special teams,
which again makes sense, the defensive line being unranked, if our assumption is correct in that O'Shawn is a part of the linebacking core,
and that is the group,
the special teams or the line,
the defensive line, and I am counting O'Shawn and Tanner.
You're gonna count them part of the line,
Nelson. I'm counting them as line because
okay.
I mean they're defensive ends. Mm-hmm. They just have a different title now. They're called edge, but they're basically going to be, for the most part, maybe not 100% of the time, for the most part, hand in the dirt or hand in the tire, the compact tire, you know, scraps, guys coming off the edge. So I count them as defensive linemen. But I think that's the group that since the spring, and when we look at this season in the rearview mirror come December, January, I think that's the group that's going to be the most improved. If you're comparing it to, hey, let's go back to May 1st and just look at all the position groups and then compare it to where they are January 1st. I think defensive line will be easily the most improved position group. It may be the best position group
on the team. Are you counting, like, you know, we're talking about like stopping the run in here too?
Possibly. Not saying it will be.
Well, you're saying the best or most improved.
I say it will be the most improved. It may be the best by the time all is said and done.
I'd be surprised by the latter. I wouldn't be surprised, I don't think, by the former, because a lot of that's based on the expectation you have coming in. And so if you don't think they're going to be able to stop the run.
Now, it was admittedly a lower bar because they were pretty thin. Remember, they picked up three. Essentially, they picked up three transfers.
Yeah, Windrew and Mathis.
And two of them were post-spring, right?
All three of them were post-spring.
I thought Wynn was before the spring. Wynn was after the spring, too.
I think all of them.
All right, so all three.
All three, yeah.
So.
And remember, one of them just joined the team.
Yes. But I think, and again, I am counting the edge as defensive line. So it might change the linebacker rankings a little bit.
Yeah.
But
yeah, because that linebacker's being 13th, it's like, holy crap. So yeah, again, it has to include O'Shawn.
Right. But I think defensive line will be the most improved group when you compare it to May 1st. And it could be the best position group when all is said.
Man, if you're right on the latter point, I don't know what that means. I'm trying to figure out what that would mean for the team this year. Because, you know, I can imagine.
Oh, I think it would mean some really
some
good
dubs.
Things.
Because I can imagine what it would mean if, for example, if like quarterback's the best.
It would guarantee a winning season for sure.
You think so?
Mm-hmm. Unless, you know.
The offense is
unless literally everybody, you know, fell off a cliff.
I mean, yeah, you're right. If you can stop the run, because again, that's what we're, given that you are folding O'Shawn Mathis, Caleb Tanner, et cetera, in with the defensive line, and they're the
means
best
you're stopping
group on
the
team.
Run, means you're rushing the pass.
Either that or everyone else sucks, yeah. It's like
it means you're doing what you're supposed to be doing. And you know. I said this earlier this week. To me, the offensive line is the position group that can mask more problems on a football team than any other group, and I do believe that. But defensive line is right up there in terms of its overall importance. And Nebraska, let's face it, what have been the two position groups that have been the most disappointing, underachieving, you know, slacking, dare I say, over the last two decades, it's been those two.
Yeah.
You know, Nebraska hasn't had a great defensive line since really, you know, 9 and 10. Offensive line, it hasn't felt like, you know, pipelines for a while. Nebraska's had some decent lines in that time, but, you know, it hasn't been up to 70s, 80s, 90s standards. But, yeah. If Nebraska's defensive line ends up being the best position group on this team, I think it's going to mean some really good things.
Adam says, in what world does John think the D-line will be the best position group on the team?
I'm not saying it will be. I'm saying there's a chance it could be.
What's the argument for that, though? Like, state your case. How does that group that I think you and I are both kind of in agreement that they're going to struggle to stop the run? So how does
I don't know if they're going to struggle to stop the run. I think that's my biggest concern with that group. That's a bigger concern to me than whether or not they're going to be a great pass rushing unit. And believe me, I know this team needs to be able to rush the passer. It's the one thing, you know, the one thing Chenander's defenses have kind of bumped their head on this invisible ceiling has been the inability to rush the passer. That's the thing that's going to break through the ceiling and really, you know, show this defense the kind of improvement. It's been amazing how much they've been able to improve in the 4 years of Eric Chenander, but I think they've hit their heads on the ceiling, and that ceiling is you got to be able to rush the passer. So that's important, but man, you have got to stop the run in this conference. If Nebraska can't stop the run, it doesn't matter how good the pass rush is.
Yeah.
Well, so yes, that is absolutely a That's a concern for me. We don't know what it's going to be yet, but I think the potential could be there.
Now, he's followed up texting in 402-951-1620. He says, any of you is in big trouble if that is the best position group on the team. That means all the other position groups are awful. Does John know? See, he's talking about a group with no returning starts other than Nelson and woefully thin depth-wise.
Again,
it's a Band-Aid of transfers.
They have no returning transfers who played at Nebraska, but they have four guys who have started multiple games at Texas Tech, at Alabama.
They haven't started multiple games at Alabama. That guy played like 50 snaps.
Well, when I combine them all together.
200 snaps?
But TCU, Texas Tech.
And that's what you're basing a lot of this on, right?
Sure it is. But also, you know, we've heard so many good things about Colton Feast. They really like what they're seeing there. Nash Hutmacher could end up starting at least just the beginning of the season over Wynn. They seem to like the depth they have there. And if it's true, and remember, I'm counting the edge as part of the defensive line.
Mm-hmm.
They love O'Shawn.
You sound bullish, though, I guess is what I would say.
I do sound bullish.
I'm surprised, because I don't think they're going to stop the run very well. I'm interested to see, in all seriousness, Skaronski, who is the really good defensive or offensive mm-hmm. lineman for Northwestern. They play good offensive linemen this year, you know, up and down the schedule. What happens against those guys? But, I mean, especially in game one, look, Northwestern couldn't run the ball last year, and they got this NFL lineman on their roster. Like, I think that that's a nice kind of barometer. If you're right, look, I don't know if we will know you're right after game
no,
one.
No, we
but
won't.
We can definitely
we won't.
Know if you're wrong. Because if Northwestern's able to run the ball, then it's like, oh, boy. I mean, Northwestern's still a long way.
Yeah, but we got to always be careful not to overreact too much to one game.
Again, from the perspective, if you're wrong, we'll know early. If you're right, in my opinion, we won't know for a little bit. But if they struggle in this game, then I don't really have hope for them in November. Stopping the run.
Which group do you have more confidence in right now? Offensive line, defensive line?
Defense. But not, I mean, my trust in the offensive line is pretty low. Pretty low.
But the other position groups that were ranked. And again,
yeah, special teams, that one, that being unranked. And I guess though,
well, that's
not
surprising,
but we don't,
all.
Yeah, I would love to know how deep the numbers go. Cause we got this from Sam McEwen's Rewind from last week. So I don't know how many teams he ranks, but you know, this top 75 cake, if special teams able to get in the top 75, I think they'll be in the top 75 on special teams. So I think they'd be ranked.
Right. But he's going off of what they are right now, what he thinks they are right now.
No, I'm saying, I think that they're going to be top 75.
They could.
I'm more bullish on that than you are on the defensive line. Or not, I guess maybe I'm not more bullish. I'm way more confident in that than I am in you being right about the line.
But it's not. My concern with special teams is more in the return and return coverage, not as much in the kicking. I think kicking, they'll be fine. My bigger concern is how are they going to be returning the ball and stopping the return?
I think they'll be solid at returning. Stopping. Great point.
Those are more concerning to me than the actual kicking part of the special teams. Any of those other, I was a little surprised Nebraska's offensive line rated that high.
That high?
I mean, it's 67. It's still top half. Well,
barely.
Half-ish.
Yeah. Yeah. That's a good point. I was surprised the quarterback was that low. Because if Nebraska's quarterbacks are ranked 57, and again, this is the collective depth and everything, mm-hmm. but let's just say that Casey Thompson is the 52nd best quarterback. That's bad. It's going to be hard to make a bowl game.
It is not great.
Yeah. Now, I don't know if he's right or wrong there, but that number definitely popped to me because I was like, wow, that's low. That's low.
So you think that's the worst of the rankings? The worst in terms of the one he missed?
I don't know. It was just the biggest surprise, I think. Look, again, the linebacker part of this is hard because you're right again that he's probably including O'Shawn Mathis, but I thought that number was a little high. I thought also underrated, I thought defensive backs, 56. That definitely seemed low. Definitely seemed low.
But most of the starters are gone.
Yeah, I trust the coach, though. I trust Travis Fisher. Trust him.
Okay.
34th at receiver, I don't think is the worst thing in the world, given all the new bodies.
No, it's not.
That would be okay. You just need one of those guys to be a dude.
44th at running back?
Yeah, I don't. Hard to argue. You know, that's such a toss up for me at this point in time, because they've been so up and down in the Frost era. But a brand new coach, so that's kind of what you want to argue that one's underrated. That's the reason why, because they have a new coach and maybe he can get more out of them this year.
Reaction thoughts 402-951-1620. You can also use that as the text line. You can also hit us up on the J Tech Construction Zone Twitter feed at USC1620, or the Equitable Bank inbox, John at 1620thezone.com or Josh at 1620thezone.com. Still to come, Mitch Holtis at 4:30. And in the next hour, we'll preview Texas A&M. They are team number
7
in 25 teams in 25 days on 1620 The Zone.
Hey everyone, Josh Peterson here for my friends at Kugler Vision. You know, we'll be out there on the golf course tomorrow, and one of the biggest benefits for not having to worry about the glasses, the contacts anymore, the prescription glasses, the prescription sunglasses, is going to the golf course. First of all, you can see the ball. I've been able to, you know me, I'm probably sending it into the rough all the time. Easy to find the golf ball when it's in the rough. I can see it leave my club and hopefully fly on into the air. But, you know, you have some of those days occasionally where it's really sunny, it's really cloudy. Maybe you get a few sprinkles of rain and you're switching back and forth. My dad, every time we go play together, he has that issue. I don't have that issue anymore. And that is because over 4 years ago, scheduled a consultation, went through the entire process, then eventually had a procedure done. You can do the same today. All you got to do is give them a call at 402-558-2211. Visit their website, kuglervision.com. They'll answer all the questions that you have, and you'll find out which of their 7 different procedures will work best for you. And whether it's a trip to the golf course, taking your kids to school, watching football games as the fall arrives, or a whole lot more, life will be better for you. 402-558-2211 or kuglervision.com.
Join Sharp and Benning this Friday, 6 to 10, when they officially kick off 1620 The Zone's Red Out Week as we begin the countdown to Nebraska football. Presented by Union Bank and Trust, Gary and Damon will be joined by Husker guests and experts to dissect and discuss Nebraska's first game in Ireland and the 2022 season. It's Sharp and Benning Season Kickoff Roundtable, presented by Union Bank and Trust, where your money has people. Friday, 6 to 10 on 1620 The Zone.
Your Omaha area forecast from the Godfather's Pizza Weather Center and KETV News Watch 7 on 1620 The Zone.
Mild and partly cloudy conditions will continue all throughout the early evening hours. As we head beyond 8 and 9 o'clock, there's a small chance of scattered showers and thunderstorms for the metro area. Scattered storms will continue throughout the overnight with a morning low of 64 degrees. For your Friday, looking at partly cloudy skies, on and off showers and storms will be possible with a high temperature of 84 degrees. I'm meteorologist Anthony Copeland for KETV News Watch 7.
1620 The Zone's Unsportsmanlike Conduct, brought to you by a great friend of the program, Union Bank and Trust.
1620 The Zone Traffic.
From the Burton AC Heating, Plumbing, and More Time-Saving Traffic Center. Currently no wrecks to avoid. We are getting the reports of delays for both directions on Highway 275 between Center and 165th, causing a 3 to 5 minute delay through there. Looking at about a 2 to 3 minute delay if you're south on the JFK between I-80 and F Street. Same goes with heavy traffic on the northbound JFK between Childs and Chandler. And the left lane is closed on the northbound JFK between L Street and F Street, causing delays as well. I'm Mike Neville.
This time-saving traffic is brought to you by Saul's Jewelry and Loan.
Don't let high gas prices kill your summer plans. Saul's is the place to beat the summer budget crunch with cash-on-the-spot loans to help you get out of town, book that flight, or take that epic road trip. Cash on the spot, your summer getaway at Saul's Jewelry and Loan.
Before you know it, Husker football season is going to be here, and you want to be in Memorial Stadium or following the Big Red on the road. And while you look for tickets, look no further than ticketsforless.com. Formerly Ticket Express, they are your home for the best selection of Husker tickets inside of Memorial Stadium. And the best part, you'll never pay those outrageous fees like you do at other sites. Just compare. And you want to follow the Big Red on the road? Tickets for Less has you covered there too. Find the best seats at the best prices to all your favorite Nebraska events, all in one convenient location. Ticketsforless.com. That's ticketsforless.com. Get in the stadium.
Many people go back to the dealership out of habit, or because they think the dealer is the only one who knows how to fix their car. At Omaha Car Care, we offer a better option. We have ASE-certified technicians, the technology to service any vehicle, and free loaner cars. The dealer will sell you a package of services. We'll provide the service you want for your car as your trusted partner. I'm Rick Betker, owner of Omaha Car Care,
and we'll be along for the ride.
Marvin Windows has long been known for their lasting value and beauty. Karp's Complete Home Exteriors is Omaha's first authorized Marvin Windows replacement contractor. For a free estimate, call Karp's Complete Home Exteriors or visit karpsomaha.com.
French food, and not just small portions and high prices. Le Voltaire is anything but. Come visit Omaha's own little corner of France for mouth-watering appetizers and entrees, plus melt-in-your-mouth desserts. Dinner with friends, special occasions, entertaining clients, or just chilling with French wines and craft cocktails with your favorite someone. Le Voltaire will make you feel right at home, just like they've been doing for more than two decades. Le Voltaire just off 156 and West Dodge Road in the Pepperwood Village and at LeVoltaireOmaha.com.
There are actually two kinds of cigars. The first is the one you smoke with beloved family and friends. The second, the one you enjoy with friends you've just met. And you'll find both at Hearth Cigars and Pipes Lounge. At Hearth Cigars and Pipes Lounge, there's a well-stocked humidor with some of the best bands from around the world and a bar with your favorite cocktails and other drinkables. So what do you say? Which cigar will you be enjoying tonight? Hearth Cigars and Pipes Lounge, just off I-680 and 48th Street next to Cubby's.
Make the right call, fans. The Rooferies at John Higgins Weather Guard.
Rooferies.
This is Unsportsmanlike Conduct with John Bishop and Josh Peterson.
Part of it is that he is just so wrong.
Of 1620, The Zone.
Ha! Isn't that cute? Orioles think they're a playoff team.
Aren't they a playoff team?
Not if they keep losing to my Cubs.
Look at that home run.
That'd be that's my favorite. Ortega! 2-0. Good guys. Email. Drew, Equitable Bank inbox.
What up, Drew?
Based on Frost's first four season game ones, I guess he means to say
the opener.
First four openers. I think we have every right to overreact to game number one. All four seasons have gone the way of their game one.
That's true!
It's true, but when I was referring to it, I was referring to it from a positional standpoint. Like if a running back has a bad game one, doesn't mean the rest of his season's going to suck.
No, I
if
agree with you.
If the defensive line doesn't have a great game one, doesn't mean the rest of their season's going to suck. But yes, Drew is right. The season generally has kind of gone the way of game one, but that's more from a between the ears
yes
standpoint.
So for the record, why I was making that argument was this. Last year, Northwestern's rush offense was 86th in the country in terms of yards per game. If you look at yards per carry, they were even worse. They were 97th in the country. You look at what they did in the game at Nebraska, 26 carries, 37 yards. It was their worst game on the ground all year, 1.4 yards per carry. So what I was saying is, if they succeed in running the ball versus Nebraska, that would, for me, put up all of the alarm bells.
But what if Northwestern's better at running the ball this year?
I mean, they could be, but Nebraska should not allow them to run the ball well. If you are correct, and I'm going off of your hypothesis of this could be the best group on the team. If you are right, Northwestern won't do that. If you're right, Northwestern will not do that. If you're wrong, Northwestern could do that. That was the point.
You know what I hope happens? Open Northwestern rushes for 400. And then you wow. come back here the following week. Nebraska still wins.
Oh, okay, good.
And you come back and say, see, Joe, you were wrong. And then the rest of the season, they're just like the steel curtain. They're just like, no one runs on us anymore.
If they do that, here's what I will do. I will come on the air after Black Friday.
And I'll apologize.
I'll say, John, you were right. And I was a big, dumb idiot. But they have to rush for 400 yards. And then Nebraska has to turn in the steel curtain. Otherwise, I'm not going to say I'm a big, dumb idiot.
Well, he just did. Could you mark that? He just
no,
said,
no, don't mark it. Don't mark it.
He just said,
don't
I am a big
mark
dummy.
It.
He did say that.
Don't mark it.
Speaking of things that aged awkwardly. So, you know, when we got news of the Big Ten contract today, the TV deal, the huge TV deal, and the fact they're going to be on Fox and NBC and CBS, you know, I went back through the historical Rolodex, and, you know, it's been a while since Nebraska's played on CBS. It's been a while played on NBC.
Let me guess. So I don't know the answer for a CBS game. I assume. Oh, wait. 1998 Orange Bowl.
On CBS?
Yes. Because after that, the BCS took over and all of the major bowl games moved to CBS.
The Cotton Bowl was on Fox the last time Nebraska played in that. Unless they played, because when's the last time they played a non-conference game versus an SEC team? I believe it is. I think it's the 1998 Orange Bowl. Now, before that, besides Orange Bowls, a regular season game on CBS?
The last regular season game on CBS.
That's probably like an Oklahoma game in the early 90s?
Yes, 1990.
Oh, it's been that long. Yeah. Wow. And because then ABC started doing stuff in 91.
And, of course, on NBC, because they've only done regular season Notre Dame in the modern era. 2000. It's only the 2000 game.
And before that, you got to go back to what? The 95 Orange Bowl. Mm-hmm. Smile, Tom.
But upon doing some research today, do you know who spent a year doing games and analysis for CBS?
Chris Collinsworth?
Be Trev Alberts.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I remember that. Yeah, he was on College Sports TV.
Which is the precursor of CBS Sports Network.
This was his job. This is before he's an athletic director, but after he kind of got fired by ESPN or whatever happened with him and ESPN.
Yeah.
That he, because I remember watching, he was on with, I believe, Aaron Taylor and.
Well, you should be on with Mark May, and they used to.
No, I'm saying CSTV.
I found this piece of video today that I thought I would share. It's pretty funny. Can you bring up the audio on this computer over here? Because we're going to play this.
It's on the board, Conrad.
Yeah, I'll just bring up the fader on the board there, because I'm going to play this off of our StreamYard. So this is Trev Alberts. He's doing a mailbag segment.
Do you know what year this is?
Well, it's during Tim Tebow.
So either 05, 06, 07,
yeah, I think it's like 05. I think it's rank 05.
Okay.
Listen to this first question and how he answers it. Hello. Can you bring up the, just bring up that fader.
Hello and welcome.
Turn up the one next to it, Conrad. Yeah, do that one. Try that one.
Hello and welcome to.
Oh, you know what? It's muted on the computer. That's why. Does it have to be unmuted off that computer? Oh, guess I should have just planned on playing different audio. Tell you what, we'll fix it.
Okay.
And we'll play it a little bit later because it's pretty funny and it's very ironic.
And it's time to talk to Mitch Holthus anyway.
That's right. So Mitch Holthus will join us next. Dundee Day is coming up.
When is this sucker? It doesn't say.
This Saturday.
Saturday.
This Saturday.
That print is so small. Well, this Saturday.
This Saturday, John. It's Dundee Day.
100 vendor booths, a 5K run through Dundee. No Josh Peterson.
Sorry.
Daytime performances by Street Percussion, School of Rock, and other community groups. Dundee Night, local food and drink with nonstop live music 4 to 12. Visit 1620thezone.com for more details.
You could win $5,000 to have the ultimate tailgate party on 1620 The Zone. Enter now at 1620thezone.com.
It is Big Red Friday, August 26th at McDonald's. You'll score a limited edition Husker flag for just $5. You're looking for a good cause? The proceeds benefiting your local Ronald McDonald House. That's a good deal. Those families, they go through enough. We want to take the burden off of those families by supporting the Ronald McDonald House. Should a Husker fan like you need a flag? Absolutely. Stop on out. It's Big Red Friday, August 26th at your local McDonald's.
Question 5. Lucas and Carla have 3 homework assignments each. Lucas does his online at home, but Carla has no internet at home. If Carla has to travel 5 miles to find Wi-Fi at a noisy diner or a grocery store parking lot, how can she ever be expected to do well in school?
This is not a problem kids should have to solve. Cox Connect to Compete, providing affordable internet to lower-income students. Available to new residential Cox Internet customers who meet eligibility criteria. Other restrictions apply.
Tide presents Laundry Truths, Cold Heart Savings.
Oh, hey, about to start a load. On hot? You know, washing in cold water with Tide can save you up to $150 a year on your energy bill.
$150? Go on.
The lower the temp, the lower your bills. Simple. Plus, Tide Pods are designed for a powerful clean, even in cold.
Wow, cool tip. Get it?
Oh yeah, I get it.
Turn to cold and save with Tide. Energy savings based on average from switching from hot to cold in non-AC machines.
Would you rather that your roof or siding last 5 years or 50 years? I'm Dan Thompson of Thompson & Thompson Third Generation. Products today last much longer. Gone are the days of just tear shingles off, nail shingles on. Whether it's impact resistant, high wind tolerance, or in the case of EuroShield, hail proof rubber shingles, you can have great designer looks and durability. At Thompson & Thompson Third Generation, we don't just give you an estimate, we educate you and give you options. So you decide, 5 or 50. Click Thompson Third today and start enjoying your new roof or siding.
I always wanted to learn Spanish, but I never thought I'd have the time. Then I discovered Babbel.
Babbel's lessons are fun. They only take like 10 or 15 minutes, and in 3 weeks, presto, you're speaking another language. Like magic.
I love that Babbel's lessons aren't just robots talking. They're voiced by native speakers, so you get the pronunciation just right. And they're designed by real language teachers, so you learn how to have real-world conversations, things you'll actually use.
3 weeks. It's incredible. After 3 weeks, I'm on vacation in Paris, having a conversation in French.
There's all kinds of ways to learn. Use Babbel's podcasts or games or videos. You can even join live classes with a language teacher.
If you want to learn a language, there's no faster, easier, better way than
Babbel.
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 Babbel. Évidemment.
Go to Babbel.com to try for free. That's B-A-B-B-E-L.com. Babbel.com.
Your neighborhood is more than blocks of buildings. It's the people who live there that make it special. At Union Bank and Trust, we're not just creating home loans. We're making neighbors. We're not just small business lenders. We're small business shoppers. We don't just live in your community. We help you build it. Because our people are your people. Visit ubt.com/neighbor to learn more. Union Bank and Trust, member FDIC.
Experience every pitch, run, and legendary play. Your home for Royals baseball in Omaha. 1620 The Zone.
1620 The Zone's Unsportsmanlike Conduct is brought to you by Union Bank and Trust. Now back to the program.
And now, a Kansas City Chiefs training camp update brought to you by Hy-Vee, where there's a helpful smile in every aisle. And now, fresh off the salad bar from one of Hy-Vee's over 240 locations, the voice of the Kansas City Chiefs, Mitch Holtis.
Touchdown, Kansas City!
One of the biggest things for me is everything I do doesn't have to be a vicious, like, knockout blow. You know, sometimes being under control and fitting up is more effective. So just taking the coaching from, Coach Heck, just applying that and just being more detail-oriented with my game all around.
Going for the knockout blows, it like a boxer? Like, I wait for, then I strike? I mean, because you'll hit a knockout blow.
Yeah, there are opportunities. The times when to take that opportunity and when to, pull back a little bit. That's sort of where I need to grow in a little bit.
Now, Mitch, you can't knock a guy out. You can't just swing your fist. They made that illegal, the head slap. You can't do that anymore. Mm-hmm. What are you trying to encourage these kids?
Well, Trey Smith, offensive linemen, we don't think of them as being fun to watch, you guys.
Right.
But Creed Humphrey and Trey Smith are fun to watch. There are times I can't watch them doing the play-by-play. I've got to follow the football. But when I do my video review, I just start laughing. They will corkscrew dudes into the ground. Trey Smith was called the steal of the 2021 draft. The Chiefs get him in the sixth round. He's a first-round talent. And I'll tell you this, in 29 seasons with the Chiefs, there's only one guy that has surpassed Trey Smith. And I know he's only going into his second year. And that was Will Shields, the former Nebraska Cornhusker in the Pro Football Hall of Fame. Trey Smith is an animal. He's a gentleman. He'll help you up. He'll take the oxygen out of your left lung, help you up, and then take the oxygen out of your right lung. He is fun to watch, but he's also learned that not every shot has to be a kill shot, that he is such an asset for this team and for Patrick Mahomes.
What does he do that reminds you most of Will Smith? Are there things you think he might do better than Will Smith? Or Will Shields.
Well, he's bigger than Will.
Will Smith. Speaking of slapping.
Wow. That was a Freudian slip. Will Shields.
Yeah. And in the great movie Independence Day, it might have been the stupidest movie of all time. Like, what is this plot? Or Men in Black, like Will Smith. But Will Shields was a phenomenal athlete at right guard, very underrated, and wasn't a small guy, and he was powerful. But Trey Smith brings this WWE element to the Chiefs offensive line. He's really a throwback, as Trey, to the 60s and 70s, because he is coming at you. And he's doing so with a vengeance. And I would say just having a little more of that edge for Trey Smith, and Will would kick me in the butt, I think, if he heard it. But you asked me, and I think that's the case. But Trey Smith's a talent now. And, again, one of the top-rated offensive linemen, and side-by-side with his buddy Creed Humphrey, is definitely a dynamic duo at center and right guard. These guys are like the old Husker offensive lines of the 80s and 90s.
Mitch, we talked about, I think yesterday, maybe earlier this week, about cuts, of course, and just kind of how that schedule works. Along those lines, what are you keeping an eye out for in this matchup, 48 hours from now, versus Washington?
Yeah, look at running back first. Running back is unique now and interesting for both teams, because Washington's thinking about even redoing their depth chart. And for the Chiefs, somebody's going to get nudged out. Is that Derek Gore? Is that Ronald Jones Jr., the veteran from Tampa Bay? I'm not sure. That is definitely one to watch. And I would say, two, of the wide receiver position, and how many do they keep? Now, the Chiefs are dealing with some injuries. Juju Smith-Schuster missed another day of practice with a knee injury. Mecole Hardman is growing. Hardman is growing. Yesterday we talked about, isn't serious, but it's problem or a nuisance. He won't play. So who's going to fill in and who can win a spot? The backup offensive line has got, there's no more questions than answers. That's something that they got to run the ball. And some of these second team guys have got to look good doing it, or the Chiefs will look elsewhere to try to fill in some gaps. On the defensive side, guys, I'm telling you, it's getting pretty close to being set. And that's odd, because it's just usually the flip-flop for this Chiefs team.
Mitch,
but I would say the biggest chase there is on the defensive line, where like a guy like Taylor Stallworth is battling Danny Shelton, who the Chiefs just picked up, or a Colin Saunders. That's getting crowded there, too, on the interior defensive line especially.
Mitch, we mentioned Mecole Hardman yesterday. Andy Reid's media session today, he intimated he might be able to play on Saturday. Would that surprise you?
Yeah, a little bit. And I visited with Coach this afternoon, and we didn't get into 20 minutes of Mecole Hardman. It would, I think. But I'm not going to rule it out. And if Coach is intimating that, then hey, maybe. But I could see him setting this one out and maybe getting a few snaps against Green Bay, because there is a lot of time after the Green Bay Thursday night game this next week until the opening game against Arizona. But it leads me to another spot in Josh's question that I left out, and it may be the most prominent area for this game on Saturday afternoon against Washington, and that is the kick and punt return game. Especially now with Mecole out, I think I mentioned a couple weeks ago to you guys, they would like to wean Mecole off one of the two, either kick or punt return or both. Well, that's fine. I mean, Isaiah Pacheco is the kick returner right now, the rookie out of Rutgers, but who's the punt returner? I don't have any answer there. This is just blanks. So if it would be nice if somebody would just jump up and capture that job even as soon as Saturday afternoon.
Saturday afternoon in Arrowhead, the Chiefs against the Commanders. Beat that into your head. It's no longer football team. It's now Commanders. And then, as you mentioned, it's a short turnaround.
I'll ever forget football team. Like, wow, that's a really good name. Way to do the interim football team. I won't mess that one up. I just don't want to go back to the original name. But, we'll look at the Commanders and see what they got.
So are you really out on Independence Day?
Yeah, what the hell, Mitch?
Say again, what?
Independence Day? You're not a fan?
That is the stupidest movie of all time.
Good Lord,
top five,
Mitch.
Stupid movies.
Wow.
Like, who wrote that plot?
I don't know.
Well, it's an alien invasion movie.
I mean, aliens. This guy's married to a dancer, okay, and they're fighting aliens with pistols. Like, yeah, that's really I'm enthralled with it. Give me Men in Black. I mean, at least the pen can make everybody forget everything.
Wow,
I've never heard anyone that didn't like Independence Day.
The best presidential speech, fiction or real, that we have ever heard was in that movie, Mitch.
Give me Hitch. Like, I know it's romantic.
Give me Hitch. What?
Give me something. Will Smith needs to talk to these scriptwriters and, like, quit putting me in stupid movies. That's all.
Well, he needed to talk to the scriptwriter during the Academy Awards. That's who he needed to talk to.
I didn't go there. You notice that. I did not go.
All right, Mitch, hold his voice.
Otherwise, we could talk about Mariano Rivera and Don Zimmer, right?
We could. That's another classic.
Yeah.
That is Mitch Holtz, the voice of the Chiefs, brought to you by Hy-Vee, official grocery partner of the Kansas City Chiefs. We will talk to you tomorrow. Thank you, Mitch.
Give you game preview. Give you some more insight into this game. Talk to you tomorrow.
All right. There he is. Mitch Holtz is joining us here on Unsportsmanlike Conduct.
Look, I've never heard anybody say they didn't like Independence Day.
I'm curious if he just hates alien movies, because that's kind of what it sounded like.
Maybe. He didn't like Men in Black either. The forgetting joke. Yeah, I am a mark for Independence Day. I watched it again, not this summer. I watched it last summer for the first time in a few years. Holds up extremely. Is it dumb? Yes. It's an alien invasion movie.
Yeah, but when you compare when you compare it to other aliens invade, I mean, there's some believability to it. I mean, I know it's a fantasy.
Sure.
But it wasn't like goofy.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't think.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
I rank it personally up with Mars Attacks, and I love Mars Attacks.
See, that's a movie
has the crazy plot and all the weirdness.
Yeah, that is absolutely ridiculous.
You know, killing him with Slim Whitman.
But... Spoiler alert, I haven't seen that movie.
Well, that may be another one that goes in the movie club.
Yeah, I was going to say, is it in the
movie? By the way, The Gray Man is the movie this week. It's streaming on Netflix.
Netflix, yes, indeed.
And that'll be reviewed tomorrow when we are live at Golf Flash, Miracle Hill Golf and Tennis, just off 120th and Dodge, just north of 120th and Dodge. It's sold out. There's no more space for you to join the tournament,
man.
But you could still join us if you want.
That's true. Top Tracer building will be there for you.
Top Tracer's open. The clubhouse is always open. You can just sit and drink if you want. You can come out and just sit around with us if you'd like.
Also, you know, we have been there. This is fifth annual. You know those terms, John. Annual means we've been there every year.
Right.
You know, we've had a few of those Fridays where we're sweating up a storm. You know, you know what my chair looks like.
Uh-huh.
Not good for anybody to see. Have you seen this? Have you heard about this? Have you seen the forecast for tomorrow?
I'm guessing it's going to be like today.
A high of 81.
That's pretty cool.
Oh, I mean, literally.
Yeah.
This is going to be, put it on the list. This will be the best weather we ever have for Golf Flash. I am so excited.
You could be right.
God, I hope I didn't just jinx it for tomorrow.
Why would you jinx it?
Like, what if snow comes now? Because I'm like, this is going to be the best.
Okay, now see, that's what...
I'm just concerned. What if I did jinx it? What if I did?
You should never, ever quote the weather again.
Never?
Never.
Never, ever?
Never, ever.
Okay.
Happy Hour is next on Unsportsmanlike Conduct and 1620 The Zone.
1620 The Zone Traffic.
From the Burton AC Heating, Plumbing, and More Time-Saving Traffic Center. Currently no wrecks to avoid. We are getting the reports of delays for both directions on Highway 275 between Center and 165th, causing a 3 to 5 minute delay through there. Looking at about a 2 to 3 minute delay if you're south on the JFK between I-80 and F Street. Same goes with heavy traffic on the northbound JFK between Childs and Chandler. And the left lane is closed on the northbound JFK between L Street and F Street, causing delays as well. I'm Mike Neville.
This time-saving traffic is brought to you by Fernando's Omaha.
Thanks, Omaha. Thanks for voting Fernando's number one for Omaha's Choice Awards for Best Mexican Restaurant and Best Margarita. Grab a friend or the whole family and get your fix. Two locations and open 7 days a week. Fernando's, family-owned and community-served.
Hi, guys. It's Andrew with Brookside Medical Clinic. Is erectile dysfunction damaging your relationship? Are you sick of the pill and all the side effects? Well, welcome to the future. We have a major medical breakthrough. Brookside Medical Clinic uses the most advanced form of wave therapy. Backed by 60 clinical studies, our technology uses pressure waves to repair and open up blood vessels. We've helped countless men get rid of their ED. But what is the true end result? Their relationship, even their lives, improve drastically. If you're ready to regain your love life, call us right now, and not only will the assessment and ultrasound be free, we'll also give you a gift that produces immediate results in the bedroom. It almost never fails. This is worth $550, and it's free to callers right now. 402-671-7777. That's 402-671-7777. Put a stop to your erectile dysfunction and experience what I call the happiness ripple effect. Call Brookside Medical Clinic now. 402-671-7777.
Do you have big plans for your business? Get access and get growing. If you need a commercial loan or line of credit, the experts at Access Bank can help you get financing that fits your dreams. We're dedicated to supporting owners and entrepreneurs like you on a timeline that fits your schedule, because we're here for a reason, to help Omaha grow. Get started today at accessbank.com. That's accessbank.com. Member FDIC.
Are you looking for an opportunity to make a difference? Join AmeriCorps. Serving as an AmeriCorps member, you'll make meaningful impacts and connections to help build your career. Whether your passions are saving the environment, fighting food insecurity, or traveling, there's an AmeriCorps program that's right for everyone. Plus, you'll earn a living stipend and an education award for your service. Find out the program that fits your goals at serve.nebraska.gov/service. Paid for by Serve Nebraska. Aired by the Nebraska Broadcasters Association and this station.
Shop Woodhouse Place Hyundai and Nissan, 144th and Giles, KOZN Bellevue, Omaha, Council Bluffs.
It'd be nice to have a pro throw. It would be nice to have a pro throw. It would be nice to have a pro throw. It would be nice to have a pro throw. It would be nice to have a pro throw. It would be nice to have a blow
throw.
It would be nice to have a blow
throw.
It would be nice to have a blow
throw.
The happy hour is on the air.
It is happy hour time on this Thursday. Welcome back. Great to have you with us as we celebrate the Big Ten's big contract. Some other details that have come out, just kind of gleaning from other stories and other interviews. I opined earlier, I think it was earlier this week, that the days of the conference announcing schedules years in advance, not the non-conference, just the conference schedules years in advance, may be over. You know, it used to be that, heck, back in the olden days, you used to have the conference schedule set for like 7 or 8 years at least.
Very annoyingly.
And in recent years, maybe it hasn't been quite as long. Maybe you go 2 and 3 and 4 years out. Well, Gene Smith, the athletic director at The Ohio State.
Yeah.
Was being interviewed by Cleveland.com. And I'll just read this bullet point from the article. Traditionally, Big Ten football conference opponents have been decided and announced years in advance. Smith said that will change.
Awesome.
With opponents announced each October for the following year.
Oh, interesting.
He said the TV partners will be involved in that scheduling component. So opponents announced each October. Now, it may not... That's just saying opponents. So it could be like the NFL.
Where you know you're playing, and then we eventually find out when.
Yes. It would not surprise
they
me.
They should. They should have a big, you know, play it,
would,
it up.
Yeah. It would not surprise me if in, you know, let's say, well, next year, the contract takes over next year.
All right.
So next year's, away from next USC, year's Big Ten conference schedule. Because remember, all the teams took their conference schedules down off their websites. So theoretically, if Smith is right, this October, we should get the announcement of next year's conference schedule.
Mm-hmm.
But it also says opponents. I wonder, because we've wondered, is it going to be divisions? Is it going to be pods?
We're probably going to, I mean, we got to get that announcement at some point in time, because USC and UCLA, we're still a couple years off from that, but they got to announce like what the format of the league is going to be.
Now, there's one sentence I didn't
read. Do the conference championship semis. Do it, Big Ten. Come on.
There's one sentence I didn't read.
We'll read it.
He said the TV partners will be involved in that scheduling component.
Of course they will. Absolutely they will.
Here's my question. Could this mean no divisions, no pods? Really, no real formula.
Why? What? I guess.
In other words, because if you want to try to maximize as many good matchups as possible, mm-hmm. could they just decide, hey, we're not going to guarantee that Team X is going to play Team Y every year, and just roll out entirely new schedules every year without, because currently, obviously, the schedules are divisional based, and then your crossovers have been based on a formula-ish, you know, technically.
Like Big Red out week-ish?
Yeah. You know, where Nebraska was stuck with Ohio State every single week, every single year.
For 6 years.
And then it was supposed to shift to Michigan, which it started last year.
So they're
going to
get a one-off, a two-off?
But could it be that there's not going to be any guarantees that you're always going to play these teams every year? And there might be a few.
I'd be surprised.
But I'm not sure if this necessarily means we're going to see pods. So, you know, in the pod system, if you're not familiar, that's
locked in.
You know,
opponents.
Nebraska, for example, would be locked in playing Minnesota, Wisconsin, and Iowa every year, and then they'd rotate everybody else. Mm-hmm. But the fact that they haven't announced that part of it yet.
Well, because they still got to announce what they're doing with USC and UCLA. Because that's the curveball.
Exactly.
Dan says, this sounds like we might have Rutgers on Black Friday. Yuck. Dan, that ain't happening. See, this is like the galaxy brain stuff with new contracts that always confuses me. Like, no, they're not going to do that.
Well, no, I'm not saying they're going to put Nebraska Rutgers on.
Dan is, though.
No.
It's still going to be, look, it's going to be
normalized. No, but they're going to, listen, Black Friday, they prioritize this now. They're going to put a game on CBS. They're going to put a game in primetime. You're not going to get Nebraska Rutgers in primetime on Black Friday.
Like you always do. It'll still be Nebraska and Iowa. That ain't changing.
I don't know if you're
beating a little galaxy brain on
no,
this.
No, I'm not.
I think you
no,
are.
No, I'm not.
You're reading that and you're saying this means they could change everything. Like why,
it could. It literally could.
Why wouldn't they keep Nebraska?
He said
and
opponents
Iowa?
Opponents announced each October for the following year.
That doesn't mean it has
and
to
TV
change
partners
when
will be
it
involved.
Is, though. It just
well, it
just,
is going to change.
Not Nebraska and Iowa. Put it on the list. They're not moving that. It just got the biggest viewership ever on BTN. They're not change that. What? Why would they change it?
The only thing that we know is that one thing we know is not going to change is Ohio State, Michigan.
That will be
that
on that
change.
Saturday for sure.
But I do. I would prepare yourself for maybe a scheduling idea that no one else has thought of.
Like
yet.
What?
Or I don't know. That's the thing. I don't know.
I know. Just again, I'm just like, what? What is happening?
Well, but we always get stuck in these ruts.
Yeah.
Where it's like, it's always been this, and now someone came up with this idea, and these, it's either this basket or this basket. The Big Ten, who has already shown that they're willing, hey, 4 months ago, this idea of Fox, CBS, NBC, mm-hmm. no one was thinking that.
No.
And it happened.
Mm-hmm.
All I'm saying is prepare yourself for maybe a new way of scheduling that maybe hasn't been openly discussed yet. That's all I'm saying.
Maybe.
Now, personally,
you want divisions.
I think this is the perfect time to keep divisions because
you're
literally
expanding.
Adding two good Western teams. You throw them in with the West, and you slide
Purdue
over to the East so they can keep their, you know.
Sorry, Purdue. I feel so bad for you. You get to play Ohio State and Michigan and Penn State and everybody every year.
Well, guess what? Nebraska has to play USC and UCLA every year.
Well, in that play UCLA.
But seriously, if there was ever a time to keep divisions, I think it would be now because it's perfect. But that's not going to happen because everybody can't have divisions because they're awful.
Or you do 4 or 14 pods. And that's why, I'm going to keep screaming from the mountaintops.
That.
Finish the season with semis.
I don't think that will happen because they would have announced that with today.
I don't think so because they haven't announced any of the formats yet. They haven't announced what's going to happen. What's the difference between announcing that today and announcing you're going to have
divisions
you're going to go divisionless?
Right, but when I just said, be prepared for a maybe a different way of scheduling that hasn't been discussed yet outside of you mentioning it.
What the
semifinal idea?
Oh, I've seen that. That's floating in places.
I haven't seen it floating anywhere.
Oh, I've read it.
I only saw it floating out of your head.
Well, many are saying. No, I'm serious. I've read that like as an idea.
Well, either way,
Because I think that'd be really cool. Because...
I would have thought though, if that was going to be an idea, because those are playoff games, that if they were going to go that route, that they would have announced it with this today. Maybe I'm wrong.
Yeah.
I don't know.
You have a goofy idea and I can't have a goofy idea?
No, you don't.
Goofy idea?
I didn't say your idea.
Be prepared. Everything's different.
I endorsed your idea.
Meanwhile, I'm like, here's a different idea. And you're like, they would have announced it by now.
No, I'm just saying, wouldn't you think they would have announced it by now?
I don't know, because, I mean, they haven't announced the format yet. So I just
because you're literally adding playoff games.
Yeah, yeah. You basically,
you're adding playoff games. Those are premium games that all of a sudden go from being just a run-of-the-mill regular season Big Ten game to being a conference playoff.
You know what? I'm wrong, and here's why. Because they already said that there's going to be Black Friday stuff. So, you know, I'm probably wrong. I'll probably have to just have a regular boring conference championship. Boring. I'm just trying to make the Big Ten money. But Dan, no. Nebraska will not play Rutgers on Black Friday.
They made a lot of money.
If they do that, you can't throw eggs at me, but you can call me
names. I would like to throw eggs at
you. I know you would. I know you would.
I do like that. No matter what they end up doing with the schedule, I do like the idea that
Jason Garrett will be on the call.
No, that's for Notre Dame.
Oh, okay.
I do like the idea that the conference schedules will be announced the previous October.
Yeah, it's a lot more fun.
That's why I say maybe prepare yourself for something different, because they're going to try to finagle schedules to be a little bit stronger every year so that every week each of their network partners gets a really good game. Mm-hmm. That's why.
And that's maybe why
I am reading a little too much into this, but I don't know.
The Big Ten has surprised
us already. And listen, for a conference that has been stuck in the mud
you're right,
decades.
There. You're spot on there. Think of all the things that they're changing. Let's run through a few of them again for those who missed it. So there will now be, NBC will have a primetime Labor Day Sunday night game to begin every season starting next year, 2023. So we will have a Labor Day Sunday. This year would be the 4th. There will be a primetime Big Ten game every year on NBC. That's pretty radical for this league, a very stodgy, stuck-in-their-ways league. There will now be 2 games on Black Friday, and one of them will be at night. And remember, this is the same Big Ten conference that for the longest time was like, we don't want November night games. It snows.
Well, now they're going to have night games every November, every week in November.
And so now this means 2 Black Friday games. I have to imagine Nebraska and Iowa will be one, because they like being on Black Friday.
Or maybe it will be Nebraska Rutgers.
Oh, God.
They're thinking outside the box.
Yeah, that's way out. That's too far outside the box, Kevin Warren. Let's see.
East-West showdown. It'll be great.
The championship game will be on Fox, CBS, and NBC over the course of the 7-year deal. Fox will have it the most times, 4, CBS twice, NBC once. We haven't really talked so much about the streaming component just yet, but Peacock will have some streaming exclusive football games.
8.
And we've talked at times about, I've had a theory that this deal was going to be kind of dipping the toe in the water, and we're still a few years away from kind of going all in on streaming.
Well, this is definitely dipping the toe in the water.
Definitely dipping the toe in the water. So I think that I'm kind of right so far, but I feel like we're still living in that era of, I mean, over the air, NFL's still over the air, a lot of their games, but they've dipped their toe in the water. They're going to do that with Amazon this year. The Big Ten will start doing that with Peacock. We'll see if Amazon gets involved in college football. What's going
to
happen?
Amazon tried to get involved with this, and according to Richard Deitch at The Athletic, the Amazon was willing to pay more
money
than NBC or CBS for those windows and air them on Amazon. But the Big Ten said no to more money.
Yeah, they turned down more money.
They could have the network access. And
fascinating.
Reading one more thing from this Gene Smith story, says, according to Smith, two priorities. First, the Big Ten, the potential television partners, CBS, Fox, NBC, needed to, quote, understand who we are and promote not only the athletes, but the Big Ten schools. Secondly, they needed to ease into the era of streaming while assuring conventional access across the league's now coast-to-coast landscape.
Gosh.
So that was a guiding principle.
Dipping the toe in the water.
A guiding principle was, we can allow some streaming,
but not going all in
just
yet.
The vast, vast, vast majority will be easy access network television.
Yeah, I think as a country, we are not ready for that yet. But I think when this deal's up in 7 years, think of 7 years ago how we were watching college football. Think of how we were watching anything 7 years ago. Think about how we're watching it today.
It'll depend on how things change, but you're probably right.
Yeah. I'm not saying every game will be on streaming, but I think that the next time there will be that'll be a more heavier component. Kenny says, isn't it a no-brainer that the two Black Friday games will be Nebraska, Iowa, and the night game of USC and UCLA? Ohio State and Michigan get all the attention on Saturday. See, now
I thought about that, but
you know, the thing about it is USC, when they host Notre Dame, that is the Thanksgiving weekend game. When they are at Notre Dame, that game's in October.
Yes.
But you know what, Kenny? Maybe it always involves USC. Maybe some years it's USC and UCLA. Maybe other years it's USC and Notre Dame. It's already a symbiotic relationship between those two teams, right?
Yeah, because the home game.
Yep.
The exactly. home game will be aired on one of those three NBC because anyway, yeah. it's a Big Ten controlled game.
Yeah. So and here's another thing. I'm going to be interested if Nebraska ever gets the night game on Black Friday. That game is, what's the latest a Black Friday game has ever kicked off in Lincoln? Like 2:30?
2:30.
They've never had a night game on Black Friday. Will that happen?
But if the USC component's involved, then that'll always be the prime time game because it's on the West Coast.
Yeah, they can do a 12:30 out there, though.
They could, but I doubt they would.
They probably wouldn't want to. Maybe they would. On the West Coast, they're weird. They don't like the night games. They actually like the games earlier. So maybe they would want that. Would Nebraska, you think Nebraska fans would want that, a Black Friday night game? Or would Iowa fans want that?
Well, yeah, because night games are always the best.
It'd be nice, man, after you eat all that food on Thanksgiving, you're a little full. Maybe
that was
sleep
the day before.
You sleep in a little bit. You know,
you sleep it off.
You're a little tired. You're a little full, a little
you're
tired.
Up by 10. You get to the stadium by 1. Oh. The game's at 2:30. Plenty of time.
But if it's a night game, you can go there and you can tailgate all day.
Yeah, but that,
and
yeah.
Then John Bishop on Big Red overreaction.
And then it'll be cold and frozen. You won't want to do that.
Brought to you by NBC.
You won't want to do
it's
that.
It's going to be sweet when NBC is the official sponsor of Big Red Overreaction.
I don't think that's going to
happen. That's not going to happen. Was there anything else that we missed on the news of the day? CBS, the first year, won't have as many games because they'll still have the SEC, which is going to be hilarious. So I'm wondering where the hell they're going to put the Big Ten. You know, because the thing
they may not have, they won't have as many games.
They have seven of the games, but I'm wondering what window will they put them in is what I'm wondering about.
Well, remember, there's some early season. There's some September dates that CBS doesn't have a game because there's no.
Well, yeah, you know what the opener is this year on CBS?
Yeah.
Arizona and San Diego State.
Exactly.
Yeah, so you put them early in the year.
They'll find some windows.
Because they really love the exclusive windows. All of the networks will get to draft weeks that they want first. So if you're someone that doesn't want every good game on at 11, no fear.
Which, you people need to just shut up. The best game should always be at 11.
Gus and Joel calling every good game. Let Nestler do it sometimes.
Fine. 2:30's fine.
Garrett do it sometimes. I demand Jason Garrett calling the best football game of the week in the Big Ten.
Listen, Cowboy quarterbacks aren't much as quarterbacks, but they're pretty good analysts. Aikman's good.
Jason
Romo's
Garrett's going to be horrible.
Jason Garrett, I'm sure, is going to be great.
No, he is not going to be great. Don't say that. He's going to be average to below average. Brad says, if the playoff expands to 12 or 16, your pod system makes perfect sense because a conference championship won't be nearly as important. See, and here's the thing too, John. I'll throw this out there about the four-division format. It allows for teams to have like kind of tangible goals that they can reach.
Yeah.
It's like a participation trophy, right? Like, hey, Nebraska is the Big Ten Central Division champion. Like, is it goofy? Sure, but at least they can put something on their stadium again. Been a while. That stadium is pretty barren.
I guess I shouldn't say I would be surprised. I don't think they'll go to four divisions.
You're probably right.
I think they've got a good, they could have a good setup now if they are smart.
But man, imagine a Big Ten semifinal. That would be awesome. How fun would that be? Fun.
Yeah. And how many people would bitch and moan when the Big Ten Central Division is like the NFC least? And the champion has a 500 record.
The division with
record.
Two playoff teams last year, you're not allowed to make fun of the NFC East. You have to make fun of the NFC South.
Well, whatever. But you know one of those divisions will have a team with a barely above 500 record, and they'll be in a semifinal, and the people will bitch.
Well, speaking of bitching, what would happen for Nebraska fans if they were suddenly in the division with USC and UCLA, and they have to go, West Coast all the time every single year? Matt says, bought an antenna in celebration of today's announcement. Nice to have, man.
Hey,
nice to have.
Don't knock it. Don't knock it.
It's free. We haven't talked at all really about the other sports. I did want to read this text from Chris in Montana. It'll be interesting to see how this affects all the other non-revenue sports and even second-tier basketball games that used to be on ESPNU on a Saturday morning. I suppose it's better that we have an opportunity to watch them at all, but what happens to women's basketball and women's softball and second-tier basketball and baseball games? Eventually, you will have to have all streaming services to keep your nuts covered if you like sports other than football. Here's what I'm hoping for. And I saw a comment, I believe it was from our dear friend Kendall Rogers of D1 Baseball. Like, what does this mean for baseball? Will we get more games on Peacock? Will we get,
no.
Like, will those game, will they, will the streaming services take over?
No.
So you think,
well, yeah, the streaming service will. It's called BTN Plus.
Ugh. That's a bummer.
Yeah. These contracts, and by the way, there was no mention of volleyball for those. And that's been kind of a recent, not, I shouldn't say recent, but that's been a, that's been something that folks have been talking about pretty strongly. The local coaches have been doing it. Dirk wrote an article about it. No mention of volleyball whatsoever.
Yep.
So how volleyball, baseball, softball get treated, at least for the moment, it looks like exactly the same as before. The lion's share of everything they do will be either BTN or BTN Plus.
Sad.
With maybe an occasional, like we have. Well, actually, the volleyball match, Creighton and Nebraska, Fox Sports 1, that's because of the Big East.
And we'll be there, by the way.
We will, because it's a Creighton home match.
Yeah, it's not because it's a Big Ten match.
Right. If it were a Big Ten match, it would be on BTN.
Yeah.
What is so it? That's not going to change. Now, women's basketball is getting a little more love in this deal.
Their final
conference championship game
will be on CBS.
Will be on CBS, and there's going to be exclusive Peacock streaming.
Saying this over and over, we sound like idiots. I really wish they would have given it a better name. They could have called it NBC Plus.
What's wrong with Peacock?
You know what's wrong with it. The name is Peacock. Come on.
It's a bird.
I know.
Nick's not here. He doesn't have to duck from it.
That's true. P-Duck. They could have named it that.
It's Peacock.
Peacock. Come on, NBC. What are you doing?
I hope they start shortening it.
I know you do. I know you do.
They should.
I know you.
They should start shortening it.
It's Nebraska. It's Rutgers.
And on the.
Yeah. See, we can't even say it.
We can when South Carolina's in town.
I feel, you know,
South Carolina's in town. What do they say? Go Cox.
Go Cox. I'll throw this out there for my sad, sad folks out there who love watching Big Ten basketball. I feel for you. But in all seriousness, I do feel for you because it's going to be harder now to watch Big Ten hoops. It's gotten difficult. It's gotten a little more difficult. Obviously, no games on ESPN. You know, you turn on a Saturday morning, Saturday afternoon, Wednesday night. You had a little Big Ten action on ESPN. Now a lot of it's going to be behind the streaming service. You know,
get yourself the
Peacock.
The Peacock.
Now, here's the thing: you could be a smart person and just not watch, like yours truly. Your life will be better for it. Oh, cool! I don't have to watch another 50-49 barn burner. Up in
Minnesota. I notice how hard in the paint you go, you know, bagging on men's college basketball. Any other sports you want to crap on and say, I don't watch those either?
Hockey, college hockey.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Volleyball.
Volleyball's fine. It's not my cup of bath.
Yeah, but you don't go hard in the paint on this like you do in the other one.
Well, if I honestly, I don't know. It seems like volleyball's good. When I watch it, I enjoy it. When I watch a lot of Big Ten basketball.
Big Ten basketball is good.
Is it?
Yes.
2 years ago, you were telling me how overrated it was.
Well, it was overrated, but
cape for it.
But it is still good.
I love it. It's, oh man, you know how I feel about college.
All right, I promised to play this earlier.
Well, can I read one more thing real fast? Joel says, Jack, this is Jack Collinsworth. There's a big third down conversion. Hey, Jason. That's Jason Garrett just clapping in the booth. No, Jason, you have to speak. All right, let's get to the audio.
He's gonna suck. It's
gonna
be funny when he is such a great analyst.
No, that won't happen. I've watched
it because it'll continue the trend of Cowboys sucking at football but being good at talking.
Hey, at least he's won a Super Bowl as a player a million years ago.
All right, I promised this last hour, but Trev Alberts used to work for CBS.
Yes,
it didn't last very long, but he did. He worked for CBS and he did some games. He was on College Sports TV.
That was the precursor to CBS Sports.
Correct. Network. And you know, and as I was trying to find was an example of Trev, you know, doing a game or something on CBS. And I came across this piece of video. Highly ironic when you consider what Trev does today.
Mm.
All right, let's try this again.
Please, God, work.
Let's, Let's see if it works. Here's Trev Alberts. This is about 2005 from CSTV, a subsidiary of the CBS television network.
Hello and welcome to CSTV.com. I'm Trev Alberts. It's time to open the mailbag. We have a couple questions this week. First question comes from Jake from Michigan, who says, if you were to rank the six BCS conferences in order, does the Big Ten come in last? It's close, Jake, not last. The ACC, of course, a basketball conference, definitely would be last. But the Big Ten, close to being last. But I think it's...
Wow, Trev.
Trev, crapping on the Big Ten. It's close. They're almost last.
Well, it's like, you know, when Nebraska joined the Big Ten, suddenly everyone around here was like, you know, that's a really tough conference.
Mm-hmm.
After pooping on it for years.
Yeah. So that drop may come in handy someday. Sorry, Trev, but it's your words, not mine.
Isaac says, maybe when streaming takes over, this will revive the in-person experience because I can't stand live sports when streamed due to delay. Real-time apps ruin it. Isaac, I get what you mean, but it's so funny. I've been now a streaming service guy for my television since 2018, and I've gotten used to it. Also, it's kind of caught up. It's a lot closer. It's a lot closer to real time than it used to be.
Yeah, it is, but it's still behind.
Yeah, it is. That's why, hey, you got three over-the-air networks. Watch with the antenna. You'll be good.
But you know what?
What?
You're like me when you're watching your favorite teams.
Oh, here we go. Put your phone away.
Put the stupid thing away. You don't need the additional aggravation. You don't need to be like Jack Mitchell.
Wow.
Who needs the aggravation, who feasts off the aggravation.
He seeks it out, man. He really does.
He seeks it out.
He does.
Put the phone away. When I do not tweet when the Rams are on. When the Cubs are in the playoffs, won't happen this year.
I was going to say, that's not happening anytime soon.
No tweeting. Yeah. Husker fan.
I did do that for
you
the Cowboys
game. If you are that, I guarantee you, John of 30 years ago, if there had been Twitter.
When John was
40. Hell no am I getting on Twitter during a Husker. No way. No way.
Because you're soft, man. You're a pansy.
No, I'm not soft.
Soft-ass Bishop.
A, I'm enjoying the game.
Are you?
And I'm focused on the game. And I'm not worrying about arguing with Biff in the basement.
Wow. There are friends of the program. I love conversing.
Put the phone away.
Maybe
wait
I like
for
it.
After the game.
Maybe I want to chat with them during
the game.
And
then call us. Use the telephone and call us.
Good.
I'm sorry. Use the telephone and call Josh and Gary on Big Red Overreaction a week from Saturday.
We'll be there for you, friends. Probably 3 o'clock.
Who needs your damn tweeters and your twits?
Friends
your
of the Grum, Facebook, I'm still going to be on Twitter for you this season. I'll be tweeting with you.
Well, yeah,
unless I'm calling a soccer match, then I
won't
be with
you. I will too as a media person, but if I were just strictly watching as a fan, hell no.
I'll be tweeting during the Cowboys games, just in the regular season when they get
because you seek out the pain and suffering.
No, because
you seek out the arguing.
No, I think I'm funny, and I
you're not funny.
I want people. Wow,
the real funny is watching the Cowboys.
Damn it! Walked right into that one.
Except when Jason Garrett's coaching or broadcasting the games. Now he's a broadcaster. All right. Coming up next, Texas A&M. Coming up next on 1620 The Zone.
Hey everyone, Josh Peterson here for my friends at Miracle Hill Golf and Tennis. This is the part of the show where I tell you, hey, get signed up for Golf Flash, but it is sold out for tomorrow. That said, of course, you can stop by. It will be a one beer Friday. The weather looks like it's going to be spectacular. The fifth annual Golf Flash just north of Dodge on 120th Street. We will be there. Stop by, say hello, tune into the Grum a little bit. Jed usually stops by, he buys us a shot, then he goes on his merry way. We have an awesome time and we will be there again tomorrow. And speaking of that great weather, you are looking to put together something for this weekend, you don't have any plans, may I recommend giving them a call at 402-498-0220. A high of 80 on Saturday, a high of 83 on Sunday, lows in the low 60s. This might be the best time of year weather-wise, as we still have plenty of sunlight and plenty of great weather. 402-498-0220. Give Phil a call and book your tee time today, and we hope to see you at Golf Flash tomorrow. They're located just north of Dodge on 120th Street, Miracle Hill Golf and Tennis.
irrational confidence.
I want to go back to the original situation. The plane is fine. Everything about the plane is fine, except for the pilot is no longer able to fly the plane. And I am the only person left in a working, usable plane that has no technical issues.
But you can land that plane?
I can land that plane.
Irrational confidence. The Connor Happer Show, weekdays from 10 to 2 on 1620, The Zone. Your Omaha area forecast from the Godfather's Pizza Weather Center and KETV News Watch 7 on 1620, The Zone.
Mild and partly cloudy conditions will continue all throughout the early evening hours. As we head beyond 8 and 9 o'clock, there's a small chance of scattered showers and thunderstorms for the metro area. Scattered storms will continue throughout the overnight with a morning low of 64 degrees. For your Friday, looking at partly cloudy skies, on and off showers and storms will be possible with a high temperature of 84 degrees. I'm meteorologist Anthony Copeland for KETV News Watch 7.
1620 The Zone's Unsportsmanlike Conduct, brought to you by a great friend of the program, Union Bank and Trust.
1620 The Zone Traffic.
From the Burton AC Heating, Plumbing, and More Time-Saving Traffic Center. Currently no wrecks to avoid. We are getting the reports of delays for both directions on Highway 275 between Center and 165th, causing a 3 to 5 minute delay through there. Looking at about a 2 to 3 minute delay if you're south on the JFK between I-80 and F Street. Same goes with heavy traffic on the northbound JFK between Childs and Chandler. And the left lane is closed on the northbound JFK between L Street and F Street, causing delays as well. I'm Mike Neville. This time-saving traffic is brought to you by Lanahan Nurseries.
Summer is here, and so is the heat. Our greenhouse and nursery sales area are always open and stocked all season long. You can relax knowing when you want it, we've got it. So visit us today. Lanahan Nurseries, 192nd and Center.
The Ford truck lineup is purpose-built from the ground up, designed to be tough and productive. Crafted with high-strength, military-grade aluminum alloy body and torture-tested high-strength steel frame with new tech to help you work smart and hard. The F-150, Ranger, and Maverick are built tough and ready to tackle whatever lies ahead. Hit the road in confidence and learn more about Ford trucks in-store or online anytime at WoodhouseFord.com, your trusted truck dealer since 1975. Woodhouse Ford.
The Omaha Farmers Market is offering the city's largest and best selection of farm fresh, locally grown produce May 7th through October 16th. Open rain or shine in the Old Market every Saturday from 8 a.m. to 12:30 p.m. and in Exarban Village every Sunday from 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. To keep up with what's in season, visit omahasfarmersmarket.org and follow us on Facebook and Instagram. Presented by University of Nebraska Omaha Methodist Health System and KETV Channel 7.
This is Unsportsmanlike Conduct.
I'm a Big Red fan, man, so go Big Red.
The 1620, The Zone. Start the countdown to kickoff of the college football season.
Wants to throw, going left. Now he did drop the ball. Aggies have got it. And it's a touchdown. Michael Clemens.
Calzada dances around on the move. He'll tuck it and run. Aaron Lawrence. He's in. And breaks through.
Goes down to the 3 yard line to A-Chain. And A-Chain's got an opening. He's got world class speed. He's gone. A-Chain takes it coast to coast. Touchdown, Aggie. For an Aggie upset win. And it's good. He got it.
It's Unsportsmanlike Conduct's 25 teams in 25 days.
You know, Josh, really, was it necessary to play the Big Ten on CBS theme when we have an SEC team as a guest? How cruel.
I'm sorry.
Will Johnson. Sorry, Will, we're just having fun today.
Yeah, we are indeed.
Will Johnson, sidelines for the Aggie Radio Network. Sadly, you just got into this league, and now you're losing the iconic CBS theme. I hope you'll be okay.
Hey, I can watch Big Ten football, too. I'm fine with that. I won't quit hearing it.
Good.
Exactly. But you'll be busy watching the Aggies this year. And, of course, Texas A&M comes in at number seven in our composite poll of 25 teams in 25 days, and it's another year and another question mark about what quarterback is going to look like. You know, Hayden King is back from last year,
And joining the fray, Max Johnson comes over from LSU. There's a five-star recruit in Connor Wigman who is in the race. Who's got the inside track, do you think, to this starting job?
Well, this one's a little harder to read out. Jimbo Fisher, when he arrived, inherited a quarterback competition between Kellen Mond and Nick Starkel. That one, it always felt like Kellen Mond was out in front of, and he won the job. Last year, Haynes King competed with Zach Calzada, and it always felt like Haynes King was out in front, and he indeed did win the job. You don't have a feel like this in this quarterback competition. You don't have that feel. You don't get a sense of the front runner right now. With that said, I think if it's going to be this tight, he would trot out Haynes King for the first snap of the season on September 3rd against Sam Houston State. That would be my guess right now, but that's exactly what it is, just a guess. I don't even know if I'd go so far as to call it a prediction because this thing is so close. It's much closer than the two previous competitions Jimbo has had during his time at A&M. At a press conference earlier today, he wouldn't commit to a quarterback, and it's getting really close to game week, and he said he also wouldn't commit to a timetable. So I would think by August 27th, when game week starts, you want to have your starter picked for the guy behind center. But I wouldn't even rule out hearing a name called after that date at this point.
Will, let's look at the guys he'll be throwing to, whether it's the wide receivers or the tight ends. And in particular, I wanted to ask you about Evan Stewart, you know, one of the highest ranked players in the country last year, you know, according to the 24/7 Sports composite poll. What do you think we see from the true freshman, and what do you like about the wide receivers and tight ends overall?
Well, with Evan Stewart, I think you see him on the field immediately. I think he's a day one starter, and I think he'll give the Aggies some potential in an area that they've lacked in the last few years, and that's the explosive play capability. If you look at the team that's always the behemoth right here in A&M's division, the SEC West, and that's Alabama. Bama beats people with explosive plays constantly. They don't care about third and six, third and eight, or third and ten because they can just go downfield and throw over the top of you. And that's kind of what A&M has lacked in the last few years. And I think a guy like Evan Stewart brings that to him. I mean, as a receiver, he's mature beyond his years. He doesn't even look like a freshman out there. His routes are crisp. He cuts well. He looks like a veteran already. So, I mean, he's going to be a player immediately, and he'll have to provide those explosive plays as well to help that Aggie offense out. You have to love the tight end room because of sheer numbers. I mean, Max Johnson's brother is here, and Jake Johnson. They have really six tight ends that you can go to. Donovan Green is an incoming freshman that's probably going to play right away, or it feels like he will. Just with the sheer numbers of tight ends, you have to love that room, and you're going to see in this Jimbo Fisher offense multiple tight ends on the field at the same time. So, and they've got plenty of options to put out there. It is a quality group without question.
Will Johnson, who covers the sidelines for the Texas A&M Aggie Radio Network, joining us here in 25 teams in 25 days. I saw a comparison. Now, they play different positions, but in terms of the speed and athleticism, I saw a comparison of Devonta Chain to Tyreek Hill because of just the straight line speed and the ability to get up to speed very quickly. He's obviously starting in the backfield or going to be a big part of what they plan to do in the backfield. Could this be one of the big breakout stars this year in college football, or at least in the SEC?
I absolutely think he can be. I don't know how much special teams involvement he'll have because you're going to protect him because he's going to carry the ball so much in the backfield, but I love to watch him on special teams because he can provide the explosives just like he did against Alabama last year. But He's got the breakout potential. And what Jimbo Fisher loves about him is everybody talks speed, but he actually can run between the tackles pretty well. He is a tackle breaker. And so he's kind of all-encompassing. He blocks well, much improved in his blocking since last year. I think the question is, you know, how many times do you give it to him a game? I mean, he is tough, But do you give it to him 25 times a game? Because you do have some good youngsters behind him that if he ever needs a breather or gets nicked up, you can give them the football. So he has all the capabilities of a breakout year. I think it comes down to how many times he touches the football. So you can't rule him out in the slot as well. Put him in motion, put him in the slot in the pass game, because he can provide you plenty there as well.
Will, looking over at the defensive side of the ball, I guess I'll ask a similar question to the one that I asked about the wide receivers, and that's about the true freshman. You know, again, the best recruiting class of all time, according to 24/7 Sports. Which freshman should we be keeping an eye on most with the Aggies defense this year?
Well, a lot of them, I think, would probably show up on the defensive front. Maybe a Shamar Stewart, an Anthony Lucas. Is getting reps at one of the defensive end spots. And the defensive front is where you lost some really good players, to Marvin Leal, to the Pittsburgh Steelers, Michael Clemens, to the New York Jets. Jade Peavy was so solid up there. A lot of the sacks, a lot of the tackles were lost, a lot of the disruption in the backfield was lost with those guys. So that's where you're really going to have to step up with some of those newcomers. And a lot of that number one ranked class was along the defensive front. So there's talent and there's bodies. It's just how quickly can they be good. So you'll see a ton of them play up front. Walter Nolan was one of the top recruits in the entire country. He's got a shot to contribute right away on the front line. So I think when you look at those freshmen in that ultra-talented recruiting class, you're looking along the defensive front for guys to contribute right away. I think you're set at linebacker with veterans, and I think you're set in the secondary with veterans. You're just going to have to find somebody to disrupt the passer to help that defense out the most.
And they're changing out coordinators too, with DJ Durkin coming in to run the defense. How might things be a little bit different on that side?
Well, when you talk to the players, they don't think it's much different, just the verbiage, just the terminology. But there's a little bit of pressure when you step into this role if you're DJ Durkin, because this defense was just incredible last year. It was almost top 10, top 5 statistically across the board. I talk about how A&M lacked some explosive plays last year, but it almost evened out because the defense didn't allow any. And they were loaded in the secondary last year. They're loaded there this year. They had depth at linebacker last year. They have depth there this year. The question becomes, do you get the pass rush? Do you disrupt the backfield? And do you do it with so many of those young, talented defensive linemen coming in? But I do think there's some pressure on a first-year defensive coordinator stepping in here because of how good they were last year. But if you ask these players, they said the adjustment was pretty quick from Mike Elko to DJ Durkin. They kind of accomplished that in the spring. They said other than some terminology, they don't think they had to learn a whole new playbook or anything like that. The scheme somewhat stays the same, and they think they've adapted to it pretty well.
Will, year 5 under Jimbo, they finished second, and third in the SEC West. I guess, how would you describe the temperature of the fan base right now? You know, the recruiting class that we've mentioned a few times in the interview, you know, obviously has been, you know, very heralded, but they still haven't gotten over that proverbial hump. Well, I guess, what's the expectation? What's the mood of the fan base going into year 5 under Jimbo?
I think the expectation is high, and I think the energy is high, but really that's because that's the only way the Aggies know how to live. That's how everybody lives their life down here. If you go to their school and live in this state, A&M football is always high energy, and that 12th man always makes an impact in the stands. I don't think there's any heat on any coaching staff. I don't think there's any pressure on in terms of that. I think you went 8-4 last year, but you also proved you could get over the hump against the biggest competition in the SEC with the win over Alabama. So you kind of proved you can do it. It just comes down to consistently doing it day in and day out. You had a quarterback injury last year, which really hampered things. There were really more injuries than that offensively that kind of hurt the process. But you know, you went into November last year in the playoff hunt, maybe on the outside looking in, but then you dropped some games late that you feel if you had your starting quarterback in a Haynes game that you probably would have won. So I think the temperature, it's not hot on anybody here at A&M. I think it's more of an excited fan base, a fan base that feels like this team can do it because of what they proved against Alabama last year. It's just, can they do it daily, or excuse me, every Saturday, really, going through that SEC gauntlet?
Will Johnson of the Aggie Radio Network. Will, we appreciate the time. Thank you very much for the preview, and best of luck this season.
All right, love the music. You guys enjoy it.
All right.
Thank you, Will.
We got it up there in Big Ten country.
We will. We will love it. Appreciate it.
Thank you, Will.
This is, you know, you end on that question, and to me, I mean, at some point, you know.
Got to get over it, right?
At some point, you didn't bring Jimbo in to win eight games.
Correct.
You brought Jimbo in to win national championships.
Or at least division championships.
And contend for division championships.
You know, like,
win division championships, contend for national championships.
Didn't get a chance to ask about it, but think of it. So here's the records. 9-4, 8-5, 9-1, 8-4. So they had a season where they finished fourth in the AP poll. But that's the 2020 season. That season
was weird.
Very weird. And so you wonder how that kind of lands to the fan base. Mm-hmm. They can't keep recruiting at this level and be okay with second or third or fourth place finishes.
And not win a division at least once every 4 years.
Yeah, and so it seems like, from reading the tea leaves and from that interview, it matches up with what I've been thinking. The expectation is not for this year's team to do that. But next year is when they got to do it. And this, because this class, this great class, on top of other great classes, will be a year older. They'll probably put together another really good class for 2023. Next year seems to be the year that they can get over it. So, like, do we see the signs of progress? It's funny, John. Jimbo, what was he so renowned for years? Quarterback development. And I'd say it's been pretty hit and miss since,
been very average.
Since their national championship season.
Very average.
You know, what they were able to do all the way back in 2013. At Florida State. So yeah, they're a really exciting team. I'm interested to watch them. 8.5, by the way, is their total, and the over is easily getting a love, -165.
Yeah, easy start, though. I mean, Sam Houston's a pretty good FCS program, but Sam Houston, Appy State, but then you Miami in week 3
at home, right? In College Station.
And then the neutral site game against Arkansas at Jarrell World. And then they go on the road for 3 straight SEC games.
Ooh, brutal.
Mississippi State, Alabama, and South Carolina.
Yeah, that Alabama game, it's funny. It seems like it's lost a little bit of its luster since what we thought it could be all the way back in May. But look, I'll say this. I'm guessing Nick Saban hasn't forgotten about that stuff. And that could be a bad game for them.
Yeah, Alabama, I'm guessing Jimbo hasn't forgotten about it either.
That's true.
All right, coming up, we have some unsportsmanlike content.
Oh,
and it's the 5K Ultimate Tailgate on 1620thezone.com. We can help you throw the ultimate tailgate party with your chance to win $5,000. $5,000 in cash. Enter now at 1620thezone.com.
Previously on The Crossover.
When you have the tin of popcorn, it has the 4. The cheese, the white, the caramel.
Oh, you're bougie. You went 4.
It's 3. Or is it 3? Okay. Yeah. But there's always one that's about 75% gone before any of the others are touched. Which one is it? Caramel?
Cheese.
Orange caramel. Oh, no.
All 3 are garbage.
Whoa!
Popcorn's not on.
Sharp and betting in the morning. The Connor Happer Show. Unsportsmanlike conduct. 6A to 6P. 1620. The Zone.
Hi, guys. It's Andrew with Brookside Medical Clinic. Is erectile dysfunction damaging your relationship? Are you sick of the pill and all the side effects? Well, welcome to the future. We have a major medical breakthrough. Brookside Medical Clinic uses the most advanced form of wave therapy. Backed by 60 clinical studies, our technology uses pressure waves to repair and open up blood vessels. We've helped countless men get rid of their ED. But what is the true end result? Their relationship, even their lives, improve drastically. If you're ready to regain your love life, call us right now, and not only will the assessment and ultrasound be free, we'll also give you a gift that produces immediate results in the bedroom. It almost never fails. This is worth $550, and it's free to callers right now. 402-671-7777. That's 402-671-7777. Put a stop to your erectile dysfunction and experience what I call the happiness ripple effect. Call Brookside Medical Clinic now. 402-671-7777.
Summer is here, and if you have a gotta get it done this year project, trust the official exterior experts of the Huskers, JTech Construction. Call them for a free estimate on roofing, siding, windows, or even solar. They're close by with three locations in Nebraska, including Lincoln, Grand Island, and Omaha. Need financing? JTech offers 0% interest for 60 months. Call 402-261-3682 or go online to yourexteriorexperts.com. JTech Construction, Nebraska's exterior expert.
Psst, come here. I got a secret weapon that'll make your family happy. Real happy.
It's my new caramel toffee cookie combo. My big chocolate chip cookie covered with caramel and toffee bits. Add any medium specialty pizza piled high with the best toppings and loads of mozzarella on top. Plus any medium one-topping pizza. Caramel toffee cookie combo.
Order now.
Godfather's Pizza. Do it.
Rock and country music's hardest hitters join forces. Yeah. Five Finger Death Punch. Brantley Gilbert. With special guest Corey Marks. November 30th, CHI Health Center, Omaha. On sale Friday, 10 a.m. at LiveNation.com. Five Finger Death Punch's new album, Afterlife, out Friday. Five Finger Death Punch and Brantley Gilbert, live.
It's not easy being the one everyone counts on to keep the facility running, no matter the weather or supply chain hiccup. But we get you, Raymond in Buffalo, and Maria in Miami, Jules in Minneapolis, and Stan in Central Indiana, taking control of everything that's under your control. At Grainger, we're here for you with experienced branch staff at over 250 locations so you get the product you're looking for. Call clickgrainger.com or just stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
It is Big Red Friday, August 26th at McDonald's. You'll score a limited edition Husker flag for just $5. You're looking for a good cause? The proceeds benefiting your local Ronald McDonald House. That's a good deal. Those families, they go through enough. We want to take the burden off of those families by supporting the Ronald McDonald House. Should a Husker fan like you need a flag? Absolutely. Stop on out. It's Big Red Friday, August 26th at your local McDonald's.
1620 The Zone's Unsportsmanlike Conduct is brought to you by Union Bank and Trust. Now back to the program.
Look, I made you some
Unsportsmanlike
content.
Unsportsmanlike content.
Content.
Unsportsmanlike content.
Content.
Content that's unsportsmanlike. Fill in Nick. Doesn't roll
fill
the
in Grim?
Like, it doesn't fill in. It doesn't sound as good as fill in Stibbs.
New Grim?
New Grim.
New Grim.
New Grim.
New Grim. But he's New not Grim. Taking over.
Right.
Yeah.
Conrad gets the role of New Grim today.
Yeah.
He's the fill in producer.
Hola.
And he speaks
Spanish. He'll ask all the questions in Spanish today.
No, I'm not going to be
able to.
Do you
speak Spanish, Conrad?
Very rudimentary.
Okay.
Yeah.
If you want to try to read any of these questions in Spanish, feel free to, and we'll try to answer them in English. We'll answer them in English.
I didn't pass Duolingo as well as I should have. Mm. And when I was in Spain last month, it was very harsh.
All right. Well,
I'm going to stick with English.
Sad.
Okay. Let's stick with English.
All right.
This is America after all. Who's speaking English
here?
Here
we go.
All right. Well, the University of California Board of Regents held their first hearing on UCLA's decision to depart for the Big Ten. One regent's assessment, all options are on the table, quote unquote. So on a day where UCLA found out that it was getting paid, do you think there's a chance the politicians could swoop in and say no to the Big Ten?
The odds are very, very, very long that they would actually do this because it is a lot of money. I mean, eventually they'll be netting $100 million a year from this contract. And we all know that politicians love their money. Politicians also like to preen and prance around and puff their chests.
Hey, I'm a politician.
And mark their territory and say, you're not doing this without...
They pee?
These folks will get their... The wheels of... politics will be greased,
nice,
if you will.
Nice.
And they'll get through this. But it's funny how much, you know, preening and prancing around these folks are doing right now about all this. Because, I mean, it's a no-brainer. It's a no-brainer move.
Yeah, look, you don't want to say there's a 0% chance about something happening because I guess there's always a chance. Hell no! They are, of course, they're going to the Big Ten. Politicians, every conference realignment story has a politician crying. And you know what happens? Nothing. They still move. They're moving.
And then they become big politicians and they move to Washington.
Yeah, they're going to the Big Ten. Nebraska and UCLA will soon be conference mates.
You know how many days away we are from the start of season?
No. How many days?
Nine. Single digits, guys. What will you miss most about the end of summer?
Oh, I mean, you know my answer, John.
What kind of a dumbass question is this?
I don't know. Yell at Conrad for
God.
It. I thought that was a fine
People
question,
trying
Conrad.
To kill my summer.
Not John, we're trying to remember the good days. We're trying to remember the things you loved about summer. Can I answer
it? It doesn't question? Even make me happy anymore.
Well, that's sad. So a few things. The NBA Finals were a whole lot of fun.
Man, oh, yeah, it was great.
I loved listening to you and Kevin and Gary and Damon, whomever you were with, on the College World Series. That was lovely. Of course, all the books. I've read probably 20-ish books this summer. It's been lovely. My runs, I've had really good training, knock on wood.
Oh, Josh runs, everybody.
And I, you know.
Shirtless.
I thank you for remembering. I enjoyed working with you. I thought we had a great summer of shows. We still haven't gotten the Jack Mitchell content idea board that we were supposed to get for 2021, but maybe we can get that in 2023. You know, I didn't really get to go on any trips because I did my trips in the spring. So I had a great summer. Being your coworker, your friend, your colleague, it was a good summer.
Kiss my ass.
All right, fair. Speaking of the start of the season... Nebraska was 10th in ESPN's initial Big Ten power rankings, ahead of only Illinois, Northwestern, Indiana, and Rutgers.
The Rutgers.
How about this? If Nebraska wins all four of those games, they only need two more wins for a bowl. Positive, boys.
How about that?
The positive boys.
You
put it that way.
Right?
And behind Nebraska's new look, all-powerful defensive line.
Defense!
Led by Chins.
The best defensive line in the country, says John Bishop.
I didn't say that.
The best position group on the team, says John Bishop.
How about the best defensive line between Nebraska, Illinois, Northwestern, Indiana, and the Rutgers?
You know what's funny is they literally play all four of those teams
they
that
do.
Are below them. Yeah.
They do.
Got to pick up wins.
And all, if they could Chins. Actually beat the teams they're supposed to beat, they'll be in.
Dude, seriously. When you put it that way, it makes the season seem so easy.
Nine wins. Mark it down.
Whoa. Holy crap.
Wow. All right. That's a bit aggressive, John, but all right.
Agreed.
I admire your gusto in this one.
Oh, gusto.
Gusto.
Gusto. Nice. A day after Aaron Rodgers expressed his frustration with the wide receivers, they were instructed to report to the quarterback meeting room at 8:45 a.m. on a Wednesday. Rodgers did not call the meeting, but he spoke extensively during it, according to several participants. It was really just giving us advice, Sabori Tour said. Basically letting us know that the Green Bay receiving corps has... always been held to a super high standard. Is the Packers offense going to suck?
I don't think it's going to suck, but you know how there will be Hall of Fame level quarterbacks, and early in the year, they will have this new group of receivers, sometimes young, inexperienced, and they'll struggle, and the quarterback will like bitch about it, but then there will be a game.
Whine and complain.
That happens, and it's like, hey, they figured it out. I think that's the Packers this year. I think their offense will be slow. I think there will be think pieces written. I'm sure that they will show up in unsportsmanlike content. Are the Packers dead? And we'll all wish it to be the case, but it won't be the case because they still have one of the best quarterbacks in the league. But they will have growing pains. That said, I'm really hoping Samori Toure could maybe be one of those young guys that emerges over the course of the year.
Maybe Raj needs to start drinking his psychedelics again, and then they'll start looking better.
Oh, that's a great idea. Just get stoned before the games.
What game do you think that they, quote-unquote, figure it out?
It's a good question. Let me pull up their schedule real fast.
Yeah, I don't know my Packers schedule very well.
I haven't studied
I don't know
it.
Who they're playing, but I'd say by game five.
Game five? That would be 1, 2, 3. That'd be the New York Giants. Oh, that's a great one. Over in foggy London town, that'd be a perfect time to get things right. Then they come back and play the Jets. Conrad, I think you figured it out, man.
Very good answer.
Yeah, because they open with the Vikings, the Bears, the Bucks, and the Patriots. So you got a couple of good teams in there, and then the Bears. But yeah, I think that he might have figured out exactly when they get good. I'll say that. Game five.
There you go.
Nice.
Awesome. Speaking of the Patriots, Patriots and Panthers had a training day camp fight.
And then it eventually breaks up.
Imagine how the Irish Times would cover this story.
Apparently there was a woman that was hurt.
Oh, that's not good.
Hopefully, I don't believe it was serious. But yeah. You're supposed to keep the players away. What is this? The NBA circa 1990 or whatever the Malice. What year was the Malice?
'03.
Yeah. Yeah, come on. We don't need to be like those crazy hoodlums of the NBA.
Wow, hoodlums, John.
Hoodlums.
The Irish Times would hate this because they hate American football, as we learned earlier today.
Well, they only seem to hate Nebraska American football.
Wait till they write their column on the Patriots. Bill Belichick, imagine what they would say about Tom Brady deflating footballs. Spygate involving your precious Rams.
Mm.
Oh, yeah.
Kansas will have sports gambling September 1st. Meanwhile, Nebraska. All right. when do you expect to place your first legal bet in Nebraska?
So hey, we're going to have the brick and mortar.
I know.
When is that supposed to be done? I'll say 2023. I say next year I will place a legal bet in Nebraska, which would be the first bet that I've ever placed in this state because I would never bet illegally. That would be bad to do, John.
Well, the actual casinos that are being built won't be done for a couple more years.
Oh, never mind. 2024.
But there's always been talk of maybe having a temporary facility. But as far as actual
sports betting, like a porta potty, but for gambling?
No, not a porta potty. Not a porta potty.
A porta gambling?
But at this point, I have no idea.
This is sad.
I'm going to play it safe and say within the next 5 years.
That would have been my bet.
Next 5 years.
With my bookie.
Oh, that's nice. 5 years. That's so far away.
The kits for the U.S. men's national team have leaked ahead of this year's World Cups. How do we feel about them, boys?
Thumbs down. Did you click on the link?
So
they're bad. Those are ugly and boring. Ugly and boring.
Well, these don't look like kits. There's no fishing pole. There's no lures.
Oh, Lord.
There's no hooks.
The uniforms, John, have leaked. The uniforms.
Well, you know what? I like them. You know why?
You're such a jerk.
Because you hate them.
No.
Because he hates America,
they're,
Conrad.
They're wearing the surrender whites. So when America's team, England,
I can't believe
wins in November.
Can't believe you.
It'll be just like, at least we'll be able to blame the surrender whites.
Creighton wears white. Do you blame the surrender whites when they lose at home?
Well, no, because they've never been jinxed before by the surrender whites.
Why is America being jinxed by these?
Well, because America's not a soccer playing country.
It is. We do play soccer. We made the World Cup. Remember last time?
They made the World Cup.
Hey, they made it. They're going to win. They're going to make it to the knockout stage. Put it on the list.
Who's the team you were rooting for, rooting against Ukraine?
I was rooting for Wales.
Oh, that's right. Wales. Yeah, Wales.
Oh, Wales. Against Ukraine, but not against America. I just didn't want Ukraine to make the World Cup.
Because you hate Ukraine.
No, I just didn't want
Because you and Putin are buddies.
No, I didn't want the possibility of like everyone rooting for the Ukraine against America.
Why do you care? You literally root for a franchise that more people hate than love.
No, no, no. It's not because I don't want people to hate America. I don't care about that part. It's
So hating America, fine. Hating American soccer, oh, that's terrible.
It is. No.
You are a horrible human being.
What I didn't want was like the Disney movieification of them winning and pulling the upset and everybody being like, this was preordained. I didn't want that to happen.
What do you mean preordained?
You know.
Oh, so you're saying soccer is fixed.
You're just annoying. You are the most annoying person in the whole world.
Wow. First they're wearing fishing kits, and now Josh is saying soccer is fixed.
KD says, sometimes John's weird soccer takes and hate on America makes it tough to respect all the other idiotic things he says. We get it, John. You hate America.
No, I love America.
You definitely do not love America.
I love America. All right, when we come back, it is time for the bet of the day on 1620 The Zone.
At Sid DeLand Chevrolet, we prioritize you and your vehicle needs. Visit our dealerships to shop inventory or to order your new vehicle. Shop online at SidDeLandChevy.com.
You are what drives us, Sid DeLand.
Chevy, find new roads.
Email any of our shows anytime into the Equitable Bank inbox. At Equitable, we take banking personally. For me, John at 1620thezone.com. The Equitable Bank inbox from 1620 The Zone.
French food, and not just small portions and high prices. Le Voltaire is anything but. Come visit Omaha's own little corner of France for mouth-watering appetizers and entrees, plus melt-in-your-mouth desserts. Dinner with friends, special occasions, entertaining clients, or just chilling with French wines and craft cocktails with your favorite someone. Le Voltaire will make you feel right at home, just like they've been doing for more than two decades. Le Voltaire just off 156 and West Dodge Road in the Pepperwood Village and at LeVoltaireOmaha.com.
Tide presents Laundry Truths, Cold Hard Savings.
Oh, hey, about to start a load. On hot? You know, washing in cold water with Tide can save you up to $150 a year on your energy bill.
$150? Go on.
The lower the temp, the lower your bills. Simple. Plus, Tide Pods are designed for a powerful clean, even in cold.
Wow, cool tip. Get it?
Oh, yeah, I get it.
Turn to cold and save with Tide. Energy savings based on average from switching from hot to cold in non-AC machines.
Just like that, it's goodbye summer and hello back to school season. Luckily, Famous Footwear has the perfect shoes to have your kids feeling their best on day one. Elevate your son's game in a crisp pair of Nike courts, or have your daughter steal the spotlight in all pink Doc Martens boots or Converse platform sneakers. All the famous brands to fit whatever your kids are famous for. Shop online and at a local Famous Footwear near you.
There's nothing quite like listening to the Kansas City Royals
to the wall leap
on 1620 The Zone.
John Bishop and Josh Peterson.
Shut up, you blind old man.
It's Unsportsmanlike Conduct on 1620 The Zone.
It's time for the bet of the day. We need to kill this segment.
Why?
Because I hate it.
But it's almost football season.
I don't care.
That's when bet of the day gets to be fun.
Okay, well, those are only for good for the weekend.
By the way, Mr. Rick says, I think you might be able to bet on sports in Lincoln by Halloween.
Well, I hope Mr. Rick is right.
I'm going to go with
I would be very happy.
Give me the preseason tonight.
What?
It's the NFL. Why do you get so upset? It's not your money.
You're the one that crapped on the preseason earlier this week.
I'm just not going to watch it. Are the Ravens playing tonight? Damn it, they're not. Give me the Bears on the money line at the Seahawks. Bears plus 145.
Cool.
Very cool.
Oh, gee willikers. Let's go. Let's do a parlay. Let's go Red Sox. Rays, Padres.
Oh, nice.
Plus 222.
Conrad?
I haven't won in months.
I know very little about betting, but okay. I will take the Sox and the Mets.
The Red Sox?
The Red Sox and the Mets.
Yes, all right. Yes, what does that pay?
Plus 112.
There all you go.
That's the bet of the day.
Iowa. Tomorrow we're going to be at the Golf Flash.
We will indeed.
And we are going to have a great time. We always do. And I know it's the event sold out. So if you're not already on one of the teams, you're still welcome to stop by. They got cold beer, lots of it. They'd be happy to serve you. And heck, bring your friends after work. Check out the Top Tracer building. Or maybe buy a round of beers and
for
golf.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, there's nothing that says you can't just golf yourself. Yeah. Just not part of the tournament.
Yeah. Get there, play afterwards.
Sure.
Go to the Top Tracer building. I've always viewed this, and you're going to get really mad at me now, John. I've always viewed this as the unofficial end of summer.
Here we go.
The unofficial end of summer. It's a fine afternoon, and tomorrow the weather is going to be spectacular. We're going to have a great time. Absolute great, great, great time.
And it's going to be a busy program as well because Brett McMurphy's going to join us. The talk of the Big Ten expanding has not died just because the TV contract came out.
Yeah, I'm interested in talking to Brett about that stuff.
Also, we will cheer for old Notre Dame. Staying independent, cheering her name. Because they're number six in 25 teams. And Kent will be along with the movie club.
Oh, I got to watch the movie.
The Gray Man, which is
Netflix.
Netflix. I was trying to think who are the actors that are in it.
Ryan Gosling. Am I right? I don't know.
Yes,
if I'm right.
I think you're right.
Oh, and the guy from, never mind.
From Captain America, right?
Oh, is it him?
Either way.
Chris Evans. Yeah. Oh, cool.
It's kind of a spy versus kind of, it looks to me to be like a spy versus spy type thing, action adventure. So that's on Netflix if you want to watch along tonight. And then tomorrow we'll talk about it with Kent. Of course, Mitch will be back with another training camp update and we'll be at Golf Flash. And a reminder that a week from tonight, we are going to be at Haymarket Park for the Break the Curse event with our sister station. KLIN in Lincoln. So please join us then. We'll talk to you tomorrow from Miracle.
Bye. Day.